Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to AUS TV for a big bowl matchup between the number sixth ranked St. FX X-Men up against the number 10 ranked Bishop's Gaiters. Both teams at the top of the leaderboard in the AUS here on Coulter Field in front of a packed crowd. My name is Leighton Garrity. I will be your play-by-play announcer, and join with me once more Zach Graveson for color commentary. Zach, how important is this game, being a former player for Bishops?
Well, listen, first and foremost, welcome everybody. Thank you for tuning in. And Leighton, we're in for a big one, because you said number six, number 10 in the country, yes. But conference-wise, not only do we have number one and number two in the conference, we have the number one and number two offenses, the number one and number two defenses, the number one and number two quarterbacks. Okay, this is going to be a great matchup, okay? I'm ready for big plays, big hits, big moments, because it's the Big Bowl, baby. And we got St. FX, perfect record, and Bishops ready to knock their crown off in the conference. So I'm extremely excited. What to expect? You know me. I walk around. I talk to the players. I talk to the coaches. And there's common ground on these both teams right now, and it's playoff atmosphere. Everybody in this field knows that these two teams are on a crash course in the playoffs to be head-to-head for the conference finals. So playoff atmosphere, but also bowl game. And this bowl game isn't nothing. It's very important for these two teams. I think this is the ninth one between these two teams. And the last time the X-Men lost a game in the conference in the AUS was in 2019 against the Gaiters. So the Gaiters are willing to give them another L for the first time in like 4 years.
So how do you see the boys coming into today's game? Is there a little bit more importance in this game for them through practice in the week? Do you think maybe it gets to their head being ranked nationally now? Do you think they lose focus a little bit? What do you think's rushing through their minds right now?
I think being ranked nationally is great for Bishops, but at the end of the day, it doesn't mean anything if you can't ball out on the field. So that's what they're focused on. And talking to coaches on the BU side, is there was a lot less joking around this week. It was a lot more serious, because they know that this game is huge, not only for rankings, for playoffs, and also for themselves, for confidence, for mojo. And they're trying to set the momentum early in this game, but they're extremely excited. But most thing, overall, they're extremely focused for this game. And I think the big thing between these two teams is going to be limit the penalties. We got two explosive offenses, two great defenses. Bishops, number one defense ranked in the country right now, leading the whole country with three defensive touchdowns, one being a punt block on special teams. But these two teams are ready to go head-to-head, but I'd say right now they're focused. They're not looking at the ranking. It doesn't mean anything at the end of the day if you don't win in the playoffs. So this is a big game, but I think right now they're just focused on the opponent.
And another point that we could highlight coming into today's game, Bussey, the leading running back here in the AUS, going off for 132 yards per game. He'll be facing up against the one and only Gab Arroyo, second in the league with 27 tackles. How do you see that matchup going through?
It's going to be a great one, because Bussey knows how to put the head down, and Gab Arroyo is just a disruptor of any play on defense. He has two interceptions. I think he's tied second in the conference.
He's behind the one and only Yanni Guadfell.
So that's the thing. This whole matchup is number one and number twos in the conference. So this is great. But that matchup in particular, Bussey and Gab Arroyo, I'm very excited to see who wins that.
And so we will send it on now to our PA announcer, Mark Brisson.
Significant waterways of the Abenaki people for centuries. We honor the Abenaki's rich history and culture and pay our respects to them as the original stewards of the territory on which we gather. We ask that you please rise if you are able and remove your hats. On Sunday, the Bishop's Gaiters family and the entire football community lost a legend when Ian Breck passed away. Dimanche, la grande famille des Gaiters et toute la communauté de football ont vu une véritable légende disparaître avec le décès de Ian Breck. Coach Breck spent 11 years at the helm of the Gaiters football program and made the playoffs 10 times. He led them to 5 regular season championships and won 3 Dunsmore Cups in 88, 1990, and 1994. He was inducted into the Bishop's University Wall of Distinction in 2017. After Bishop's, Ian went on to teach at Alexander Galt Regional High School and help rejuvenate their football program. In 2000, Ian became the head coach of Team Canada and brought a team of U20 All-Stars to the Global Junior Football Championship held annually at the site of the Super Bowl, winning the World Championship in 2000. Après Bishop's, Ian Breck a pris part au remodelage du programme de football de l'école secondaire Alexander Galt et a dirigé une équipe étoile U20 qui l'a mené à la victoire en 2000 au Global World Championship. He will be fondly remembered for the passion he had for his family and the game of football. Please join the St. FX X-Men and the Bishop's Gaiters in a moment of silence as we remember Coach Breck. Joignez-vous aux X-Men et aux Gaiters en observant un moment de silence en hommage à Coach Breck. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem by Bishop's very own Evodia. Mesdames, Messieurs, veuillez rester debout pour l'interprétation de l'hymne national par notre chanteuse de l'Université Bishop's, Evodia. For tonight's game, les officiels pour le match de ce soir.
And so back here now, St. FX won the toss. They decided to defer. So Bishop's will start off with the ball here in the first quarter. Zach, what can you tell us about Coach who passed away?
Well, first and foremost, our condolences to the entire Breck family. I had the chance to be around Coach Breck for 8 years, being at Champlain before coming to Bishop's, and he would always run around the field, do his laps during practice, and he'd always stay to chat after. So I know he's here in spirit with us today, watching the boys on the field. So I think I speak on behalf of the entire Gator Nation when I say thank you, Coach Breck. You're a great coach, a great man, a great role model. We love you, Coach Breck, and you will be missed.
A big part of the Bishop's community, and everyone was very saddened to hear the knowledge of his passing. As we'll come out now for kickoff here, St. FX kicking us off. Bishop's will defend the river here in the first quarter.
One thing that's very interesting about this Gators offense that you don't always notice, but they're number one right now in time of possession in the conference. So on average, they average 32 minutes of time of possession. So they usually keep the ball in their hands for more than half the game. And not only does that create more opportunities on the offensive side of the ball, it keeps their defense, the opponent's offense, off the field.
As Hadley gets that one off, Shalul receive it for the Gators, coming upfield down to the 20-yard line, falling forward and be taken down at the 25. Last week's three players of the week here for AUS football came from both teams, actually. Hadley was the special teams player of the week. Zach Ood on offense for the X-Men, and then Yanni Gwedfell for the Gaiters on defense. So we got a lot of talent here in Coulter Field tonight, and we'll see if the Gaiters could come out on top here in the Big Bowl.
Speaking of talent, number 9 for the Bishops Gaiters, Justin Quirion, number 1 in passing yards in the entire conference, expecting him to air it out today.
As Quirion reels in the snap, play action, dumping this one off upfield, and looking to move the chains forwards there. Came down with Yanis Chartier.
Great play there, fake the run, throw it to the flat to the tight end, Yanis Chartier. Great job there, and great job of the receivers blocking down the field. Usually that's what makes the difference between a few yards and a first down. So good job there getting some momentum started off the first play.
So after the first down, Kirio and Shalu will stay in the backfield here of four Bishops up against the X-Men defense. Kirio, another quick pass, looking over towards Burnett. Unable to find his target on that one.
Timing play here by Kirio. He knew exactly where he was going. Right off the fake here, throws it on time, but just off the mark there. Sometimes that could be as simple as the receiver not being deep enough or just the quarterback being off the mark.
Trying to fake the snap count here is Quirion as the receivers will set back up.
Showing the pressure from the X-Men defense.
Quirion dropping back in the pocket. A big block there by Chaloux as Quirion dumping it off to Griffiths. Griffiths trying to get some yards after catch there as he brings the ball upfield, short of the first down marker.
Good job here, Quirion, staying in the pocket, staying calm, and finding an option outside to Brandon Griffiths. Griffith fighting to get the yards, but just short, and the Gaiters will bring out the punt team.
And so tonight's starting lineups are presented by FG and Associates, securing financial success for Bishops alumni coast to coast and proud partners of Gaiters Athletics. Find them online at fggroup.ca. As Gwadfell comes out to boot the ball, a big punt there by Yanni. Reeled in by the X-Men, they're looking for room to the outside, coming downfield. A lot of pressure there by the Gaiters.
Amazing coverage there by the Gaiters. Great punt by Gwadfeld once again. But look at the coverage here. We got one, we got two, and here come the backups. Okay, nowhere to go for the punt returner. Great job there, Bishops, pinning them in within their own 20.
And once more, you can see the starting lineups now on your screen as St. FX coming out on the offensive side of the ball for the first time, led by Silas Fagnan.
Three names to watch here: Fagnan, Bussey, and Ood, number 82 receiver for St. FX. The quarterback, the running back, and the receiver have had a lot of success in these last games.
As well, tonight's scorebug is presented by the Sherbrooke Record, the voice of the Eastern Township since 1897. Check out the record's e-edition at sherbrookerecord.com. As the X-Men are pinned deep in their own end here, we'll see if Fagnan is able to get the ball out.
You mentioned the battle between Bussey and Gabawaye, but I really think it's actually going to be between Bussey and the entire Gaiters front seven. Their front seven has played lights out these last few games, but Bussey is so hard to bring down. He is almost literally a bus when he has the ball. So it's going to take everything they have to take him down, but it's going to be a great battle on both ends of the ball. And for the receivers, for St. FX, someone who missed the first two games but who has had a massive impact in the last two is number 82, Zachary Ood. He's number 2 in receiving yards in the conference, but he only played two games. His last game, he caught 141 yards, and the game before that, 105. And I think last game, he had 2 touchdowns. So watch for number 82. Watch for 27 in the backfield, and of course, watch out for number 13, Silas Fagnan.
As Fagnan and Bussey will be in the backfield here for the X-Men, their first offensive drive. Fagnan handing the ball off as Bussey getting towards the outside, breaking loose. trying to beat another man as Guadfell comes in for the tackle.
We're going to see this matchup a lot today, folks. See, Bussy gets the ball, but the thing with him is that you can get him in the backfield, but he just doesn't go down. He could juke you out too. But here the Gaiters get him for a short gain, and we have a second and kind of long for the St. FX X-Men.
So second and six here for the X-Men. We'll see what Fagnan is able to do. As he reels in the snap, dropping back in the pocket. Quick pass out, swatted down by Guadfell. Forcing a punt team back out onto the field here for St. FX.
Good job here by Yanni Guadfell. He's got those long arms. So see the pass by Fagnan here, but Guadfell's able to reach in and disrupt the pass. Good job here forcing the X-Men into a two and out and punting the ball near their end zone. Now let's see here, are they gonna take a knee in the end zone and give two? Or are they gonna trust their defense and punt the ball? Gaiters known for blocking punts so far this year.
Already two blocks underway for them. And a massive punt there off by Max Capriotti.
This is awesome. We got two great punters today. Two great punters that give a lot of airtime. And what's good about that is that when you have a good punter, the Gunners don't have that much time to get to the ball, so the returners can actually return the ball. They're not just gonna get the 5-yard halo, get tackled right away. I think we're gonna see some very exciting plays on the offense, defense, and special teams for both the Gaiters and the X-Men.
As O'Shea Hosang was returning that one for the Gaiters, coming back out onto the field now, Shalu looking to the sideline. A little confusion here on the Gaiters offense. Getting the play in, you'll see Shalu lining up as a slot receiver. Briones is in the backfield. Briones getting room. Briones with room. First down, and Marco Briones.
The ball carry number 20. There's been a lot of attention around David Shalu, but do not forget in the backfield, Bishop still has number 20, Marco Briones. And look at that, he'll break the first tackle, and then he keeps running. He could juke you out too, but he's quick, he's fast, and he gets downfield north-south. So here, Bishops gets a first down, and they're knocking on the red zone of the X-Men.
Down at the 30-yard line, Briones is staying in the backfield with Kirion. Trips to Kirion's right as he reels in the snap. Looking to throw a little quick pass over to Lur.
Gabin Lur leading the conference in receptions with 18. That is his 19th of the season. Here I have a quick out. St. FX playing cover three. The corner's going deep. You know that the sideline's going to be wide open here for number seven. Nice throw and catch.
As they'll come in and they'll bring Mason McGriskin onto the field here. McGriskin coming out as well as Christian Sinatis as a fullback for the Gaiters. McGriskin handing the ball off there on the option. Couldn't quite get any yards. Taken down there is Dylan Minocha.
Some type of misdirection with the personnel here. You see McGriskin and Briones in the backfield. We're kind of expecting it to go up the middle, but the handoff here to number 84, Dylan Minocha. Nothing there, and now we're looking at a 35-yard field goal for Gervais. This is within his range, so he should make this, and the win is pretty good right now compared to last game. Jesus.
Xavier Gervais actually threw a touchdown pass last game for the Gaiters as he puts this one up and well within his range on that one. Field goal is good as the Gaiters will take a 3-0 lead here on their second offensive drive.
Great job here by Gervais, and one thing that might be very underrated about this matchup is the kickers. Okay, Gervais is a great kicker, but on the other side of the ball, Ben Hadley, he's my X factor tonight. This is who I wrote as my X factor, a kicker. Ben Hadley, he is number one in points right now. Did you know he has 48 points? That's 6 touchdowns. Ben Hadley has the equivalent of 6 touchdowns, so don't sleep on kickers because they get points. He's 12 for 14. His longest field goal is 45 yards. that's where I'm giving props to the opposite kicker after Gervais just made a great kick, but I just had to mention it. We're talking about kickers today, folks.
It's a battle on both sides of the ball at every single position. As Fagnan will come out, pass on the mark. Alex McDonald coming in for the tackle. That was Devon Blackwood who came in.
Great job here by Fagnan getting the ball. Very calm in the pocket, knows exactly where he's going. Ball's on the money. Right to number seven, Devon Blackwood. Good job here, giving the offense a second and about four.
Second and four here for the X-Men. Bussy with Fagnan. Fagnan reeling in the snap. A lot of time in the pocket, sending this one up. Brought down by McDonald. McDonald spinning off of a defender. Returning it back up to the 45-yard line, and the crowd is on their feet.
Alex Mack, a.k.a. A-Mack, going up and catching the ball. Interception. And then gets some yards for his defense. Alex Mack just has some type of juice on this field. Whenever he's in front of the home crowd, he makes great plays. And that was one right there, giving his offense the ball. Gators up 3-0, and now they have the ball on the 45. First down,
Gators. As the Gators will bring Kirion back out onto the field here. First and 10 on the 45-yard line for Bishops.
Briones in the backfield again, and Shalou on the motion.
Quick pass out to Shalou. Shalou now turning upfield. Trying to bring it out to the outside. Gets brought down and closer to 35-yard line.
Great way to use both running backs. Look at the motion here by 27. Just missed it, but he gave, went to the edge, faked as if he was going back in to help run block, and then went to the flat, wide open, gets the ball. And we all know what Shalou does when he gets the ball in his hands. He gets yards. Now we're looking at a second and very short for the Gators.
As you see Kirion in the backfield with Shalou, Briones lining up as a fullback here.
So usually when you see these fake counts, it's to give the offense a chance to see what's going on defense. Not much shown by the X-Men.
Shalou now carrying the ball upfield for Gators first down here. They'll keep the chains moving.
72. Great job here, some old school football right up the gut. Shalou gets the ball, north-south. Good job getting what was given.
Gators on the 32-yard line. Keeping the same personnel out on the field. As Kirion awaits the snap, brings it in now. A lot of pressure being faced on Kirion. Throwing as he was hit. Over to Burnett. Burnett can't quite come down with that one. Just underthrown.
So close. Look at Kirion here. That is hard to do, to stay in, take the hit, but still deliver the ball. And Burnett, just off his hands, got to catch that. So close, but now we're looking at a second and 10 for the Bishops Gators.
Still on the 32-yard line. Faking the snap once more here as they look back over to the sideline. Kirion dropping back. Moves it over to Briones as he was hit once more. Briones now marching upfield. Couldn't quite get enough under that one. There was Briones.
Kirion once again standing strong in the pocket. Little late there on the hit, but still able to deliver the ball, complete the catch. But just third and short, and now we have Gervais. He's done 35 before. Can he do 34?
Pierre Mass will hold the ball here for Gervais.
Can I say underrated position, the holder?
Very important position. As Pierre Mass pins it down, as Gervais putting it up. And straight through the uprights once more.
Or is it?
Off the mark. However, it was a rouge there, so they still do get a point under it.
In a game like this, those were important points. Like, they still got away with 1 point after the turnover, so at least they got points. They converted something after the turnover, but still, those two extra points can mean a lot in a matchup like this.
So the X-Men offense back out on the field. We'll see how they respond after turning the ball over last time. A quick two and out in their first drive. A turnover in the second. Silas Vanyan will have to try to get the offense rolling here for the X-Men in the first quarter. Vanyan handing the ball off to Bussey. Bussey trying to move up and coming down with the tackle there.
And there it is, the disruptor, number five. We mentioned about this matchup earlier. Bussey against Hawaii. Bussey gets the ball, gaps wide open. Look at Hawaii. Able to shed his block and then go make the tackle. Definitely had some help by 51, but good job there by Hawaii stopping Bussey short.
So second and nine now on the 36-yard line for the X-Men. Trips out to Fanyan's right. They'll try to fake the snap call going quickly here as Vanyan rolls out to his right. Coming away with that one, the reception being brought in by Ben Harrington.
And one thing the Gaiters are doing a great job at is whenever an X-Men receiver catches the ball, they are quick to make the tackle. They're not giving a lot of yaks. Yaks, YAC, yards after catch, folks. So X-Men has not been able to get a lot of those today, and that's going to be very important because Fanyan knows where to go with the ball. He's going to find the open man. Now, if the man can make a play and a first down after is a totally different question.
Capriotti will come back out onto the field here for the X-Men. Looking to pin the Gaiters deep, a high snap. A quick boot there by Capriotti. Looked like it was going to be blocked. That was Hosang brings it in. A lot of flags down on the play. Three to be exact here.
Let's see. We've seen the Gaiters block a punt before. And you'll see not one, not two, three purple jerseys. Right in the face of the punter. Oh, just gets by. And I believe we have a no yards against... Well, both teams are accusing the other team of a penalty, so I don't know.
We'll see which way the ball gets brought here.
And it seems to be...
As we'll be heading
against the Gaiters.
Going backwards here for the Gaiters.
Gaiters so far have had great field position to start each and every one of their series. A little tougher here. I believe they're going to be behind. Oh.
Illegal block, St. Effects. An illegal block against St. Effects, so.
Illegal block against the punting team.
Nope. The refs will.
Yeah. Come back out, refs. I don't think that was it.
Yeah, an illegal block here will be given against the Gaiters.
That makes more sense. Gaiters at their 25. Lots of field to go. Let's see if they could sustain a drive here.
As a Kirion now in the backfield with Hosang. Hosang, just an athletic monster for the Gaiters offense. Will gain possession of the ball. Not quite the power back they were looking for there as he was met at the line of scrimmage.
Good job there by St. Effects. Stuffing the running back at the line. As soon as he gets the ball, boom, nowhere to go. Good safe tackle by the X-Men. No gain on the play. Okay, against second down.
Deuxième. So it looks like we'll have quads out to Kirion's right. Hosang staying on the field. Second and long here on the 25-yard line. Kirion motioning Pierre Mas as he brings it in and dropping back in the pocket. A lot of time here for Kirion. Pump fake rolling out. Finds Hosang. Hosang trying to get towards the outside as he gets brought down and out of play. Completed pass, number 11.
Pass completed, number 11. Hosang. So this play is going to lead to a punt by the Gaiters, but I wish we saw a little bit more of that play because the way Kirion is able to move his feet, avoid pressure, but still keep his eyes downfield. What you see a lot from young quarterbacks, especially in USports, is them panicking, them throwing the ball away or right away going to the run. Kirion always keeps his eyes down the field, which keeps the play alive, which gives a shot to his receivers to make a play. Got the ball to Hosang, just not much more.
As Guadfell come out for the punt team, four Bishops here. Good punt there by Guadfell as Harrington reels it in. Big tackle for the Gaiters. That was number four, Alexandre Prévost.
Good job there by number four, Tony, on the hit. Oh, here's the play. So you saw how Kirillon would even do a pump fake, and after that go back outside the pocket, find Hosang. That's a great play there by the young quarterback.
So back out on the field now are the X-Men. Fanyan will drop back in the pocket. Quick pass upfield, intended target there, couldn't bring it in, was Jack True.
The play was there, right in the seam. You have number 80, he's a big, tall receiver, and Fanyan put it only where he could get it. Look at that, boom, right in his hands, but got to catch that.
So a second and long situation on the 41-yard line. Trips out to Fanyan's right. Bussy stepping up. Set to block is Bussy. Fanyan now rolling out of the pocket, sending it upfield. Connects with his target. Bringing that one in is Tyler Ivany.
Great job there by Fanyan, keeping his cool. Could have been called a holding there by the tackle, but good job delivering the ball. Good deep catch. And the X-Men have their best field positioning since we began this game.
The X-Men marching down the field on this drive. Fanyan play action, looking downfield, they're trying to find Harrington, and he finds his target, Ben Harrington coming away with it for St. Effects.
The X-Men just throwing bombs on this series. Look at Fanyan going from the 42 all the way to the end zone, right in the bucket. Great catch there on Yanni Guadfeld, and the X-Men take the lead just like that. It's 6-4 for St. Effects.
As they'll bring their PAT unit on the field, Hadley will look to chip this one in for the extra point. And able to do so.
Transformation, do you see extra point is good?
As we'll line things up here, the Gaiters will look to return the ball here after the kickoff.
And now just like that, it seems like the X-Men have found a weakness in the Gaiters' defense, throwing it deep. They were trying to run, trying to go to their guy, Bussy. Wasn't really working. The short passes, the Gaiters were quick to hit the receivers as soon as they caught the ball. It's like, okay, hit him as soon as he catches the ball. He's just going to catch it 30 yards down the field, or 40 in this case. So let's see if the Gaiters make some adjustments on defense. But first, we're going to see their offense go out on the field.
Hadley coming away here, looking for a big boot, are the X-Men. Shalu and Hosang set to return here for the Gaiters. Looking to kick things back off here as the ball is up and underway, this time going over towards Hosang. Hosang catching it in the air. Going up against two defenders. His second game in a row. Jumping over Isaac Botimbe there.
How do you think of jumping over another human when you're running with the ball? What happens in your, look at that. Just jumps over him like it's nothing. Just another draw. As if they spoke before the game. Hey, I'm going to go to the legs. I'm going to jump over you. Okay. I don't know how they do that, but it's always so exciting to see. You love it. Hosang just in. He's my Gators X Factor. He does whatever he wants with the ball. But still, Gators at their 21. Lots of field to go before hitting the end zone.
As Chalou will come back into the backfield here with Kirillon. And timeout will be called here for Bishops as they were missing a player on the field.
Bishops.
Now they're thankful it's in the first half, but that's a bad way to waste a timeout when just someone is on the bench not paying attention.
And so this game is presented to you by Bell. Get pure fiber, Canada's fastest internet technology. Check availability at bellalliant.ca/fiber. Bell doing a good job across Canada getting everybody's internet running smoothly. So with a minute and 1 second left here in the first quarter, St. Effects coming off of that touchdown, looking for a nice defensive stand here. As the Gators offense back out onto the field. Kirillon, quick pass over to Burnett. Burnett marching down the field. Just shy of the first down marker there is Oliver Burnett.
Great job here, quick screen. So we see, look at the receivers blocking down the field for Burnett, giving him just a crease so he could go up, cut up field, get some extra yards. Just shy of the first down. Good job there by Bishops.
Pick up of 8 yards.
Bishops continue going. Kirillon now with a lot of pressure. Dumps it off to Chaloux. Chaloux tackled. And so we'll go down to
Gators
and short.
Gators trying to catch the X-Men off guard by snapping the ball. Not on one, not on the first sound. On the whistle, on the ref's whistle. But did not work. Weren't able to get the X-Men off guard. And just like that, the punt team is back out.
The X-Men already have beaten the Gators so far this year. They won 22-8 down at St. Effects August 26th. And so if the Gators want to jump ahead of them in the standings, they're going to need a win by 15 or more in tonight's matchup. As Guadfell receives the snap, puts the ball up in the air. Harrington set to receive for St. Effects. Bringing it in, and Gabroye there for the solo tackle.
Great job there by the punt team. Again, so consistent. Deep punt followed by a sure tackle. Not many yards for the returner to go get. And just like that, it is the end of the first quarter. Sorry.
And so at the end of the first quarter here, we will send it on over to PA Mark Bree. Sorry, not yet. We still got another play to go.
Come on, Lane. It's Canadian football.
Jumping,
you know there's another play at 0 seconds. I'll take the blame there. I said it was the end of the first quarter.
Should have known. It's only the fourth game of the season here. Third home game. They've already played four, though.
All right, here we go. 0 seconds.
As Fanyan brings the ball in for St. Effects. Aaron, this one out, looking to come down with it. Off the mark there. Intended for Devon Blackwood.
So we clearly see a change in the game plan on the X-Men side. I think basically what they did is the offense probably huddled up and they said, we're just going deep. That's all we're doing. We're throwing deep. Fanyan, you have the arm. Guys, you have the wheels. Throw it deep. You catch it. I mean, I like it. I love to see that. It's a very entertaining game to watch.
And now we'll send it on over to Mark Breesaw.
The women's team finished in second place in the event and third overall. Please welcome Coach Jocelyn Smith, Ashley Lebel, Annika Bradley, Bree Allen, RSCQ second team all-star Macy Louvel-Naik, and RSCQ second team all-star Avery Mack. And the Gators men's won the RSCQ championship for the first time in 30 years. They dethroned the Laval Rougeois, who had won 20 consecutive titles. Congratulations to assistant coach Joey Sabo, assistant coach Marty Rourke, RSEQ coach of the year Ryan Smith, William de Sainte-Marie, William Côté, Michael Brazel, RSEQ second team all-star Scott Loach, RSEQ second team all-star Landon Harrison, RSEQ first team all-star Sean Robillard, and RSEQ first team all-star and individual silver medalist Ryan Massicotte. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2023 RSEQ Men's Golf Champions, the Bishop's Gaiters!
So we'll come back out now. A special congratulations out to the Gaiters golf team. I know two of them personally, my hockey teammates, and they were very happy and very excited to have won it and to defeat the Rouge et Or.
They
always
said the
a good
Rouge
day
Or
to wake
won.
Up and defeat the Rouge et Or.
They said they had won, what, 20?
20 consecutive.
Jesus.
20 consecutive.
Shout out to the Gaiters, men's champion golf. Great job.
And back here, we'll see if the Gaiters have any luck on Coulter Field as Fagnan drops back, sends it off to Bussey. Bussey stopped a short there.
Going with the running back screen here. The X-Men, look at Bussey being patient here, turning around, catching the ball, but just met with one, two, three. Gaiters getting 2 yards, and here comes the punt team.
Capriotti back out on the field here for the X-Men. Hosang lined up down at his 10-yard line. Capriotti putting the ball up in the air. Hosang coming in to receive it for the Gaiters. Off to his left is Hosang, spinning off a couple tackles there, getting the ball past the 30-yard line.
And we have some laundry on the field. There's a flag.
And once again, performing tonight is Spark Drumline, an independent Sherbrooke drumline co-led by Bishop's very own Michael Russo. Getting the crowd pumped up here as we await the ref's call. Zach, you said it pre-game, got to stay disciplined here, and looks like the Gaiters are set.
Illegal block by Bishops, and I mean, last time we were here on Coulter Field, the Gaiters had, they were 2 yards away from 200 yards of penalties. That's almost two full field lengths of penalties that the Bishops Gaiters just give to the other team. And I mean, they're not even worse in the conference, but still, that those are self-inflicted. Can't see that.
As Guérillon hands the ball off, Briones still marching forward. For being brought down.
Good job by the X-Men front seven here, not giving much to Briones. Briones getting the ball. And as soon he's met there by number 52, Zachariah Willems. A lot of variations of Zachary, Zachariah. I think there's three on the X-Men.
Is Guérillon in the backfield once more with Briones. Guérillon dropping back this time. Airing it out towards the sideline. Griffith's coming away with the catch. First down given to the Gaiters.
This is a great ball here by Justin Guérillon. He sees that St. FX is in a cover three. The corner is deep. That means the flat is wide open. Good job there by Griffith. Just getting the catch, getting the first down. And one thing that's overlooked is that that was, what, an 8-yard pass? But in the air, that's like 30 yards. You know how far, how wide a Canadian football field is? That's a long pass to throw. Very dangerous, too. If the ball takes too much time to get there, that could be dangerous.
Guérillon play action. Airs it out towards Pierre Mass. Pierre Mass brings it down.
Pierre Mass with the big catch and a first down for the Gaiters. Let's have a look. Guérillon fakes the run, just throws an absolute dime right in the bucket. Pierre Mass catches it. Yes, that was a catch. I just saw it on the screen. Great job there by the Gaiters. And just like that, they are on the X-Men. 33-yard line.
A 40-yard bomb given out by Kirion.
Now we're starting to see the teams airing it out. We're mid-season now. They're used to it. They're ready to air it out. The arms are nice and loose.
This time they'll hand it off to Briones. Briones breaking through. Breaking some ankles is Marco Briones.
And just like that, look at Marco Briones when he runs. Finds the gap, gets it. Whoop! Ankle break, and then he puts the shoulder down, and he gets extra yards. You gotta love to see that from the running back. I'm so happy that we're seeing him getting more carries today, because with a guy like Shalu, you can even put him in the slot, so it's not even a waste of talent. But great job here through the air and then through the run by the Bishop's Gaiters.
Now on the 15-yard line are the Gaiters. Kirion bringing it in, looking to air it out. Kirion going towards the back of the end zone. A dangerous ball there by JQ.
Dangerous ball. I think he was just giving a shot to his main guy, Oliver Burnett. He was going for the corner. And he had the distance, but just the coverage was right there. Good coverage there by the X-Men.
And so we'll have a second and 10 in that situation. Still ball on the 14-yard line here for the Gaiters. Kirion and Briones.
Lots of field to play with here. Remember, these end zones are 20 yards.
Kirion airing it out once more. Looking over towards Leur, who couldn't quite come down with that one.
Great job by the X-Men here. Two deep balls by the Gaiters. Well defended. They were expecting the deep ball, and just little short there by Kirion. If there was more, if he threw that in the back of the end zone and had to help Lur keep his speed and go underneath the ball, maybe that would have been a completion. But now we have Gervais here to get 3 points and tie the game.
Gervais looking to go 2 for 3 on the day. Came away with the rouge last time he was out. As he puts it up and through the game, tied at 7 here on Coulter Field.
And the score with 11:06 remaining in the half. St. FX 7, Bishop 7.
So far, we talked about this at the beginning of the game, but time of possession here, the Gaiters, 12 minutes, 39 seconds to the X-Men, 6 minutes, 15. That is more than double the time of possession for the Gaiters, but we have a tie game. So what does that mean? Is that St. FX have found a way to score quick. They get the ball quick down the field with the deep game. Let's see if the Gaiters adjusted here on defense.
As Bussy will be in the backfield with Fanyan. Hand off to Bussy. Bussy rolling upfield. A couple flags down on the play.
We got a couple flags. And what the deep game does when Fanyan can complete those deep balls is that makes the defense back up a bit and gives more room to Bussy. Not on this play, though. And I believe the penalty is on the X-Men for holding.
Holding up against the X-Men, and so we'll back the ball up 10 yards. Repeat first down. So first and 20 now on their own 25-yard line. A lot of field to go here for the X-Men. Fanyan faking the count. Reeling in, dropping back, a quick pass towards the outside. A nice reception as they'll come back up on second down. It'll be second and long here.
Great catch here by Tyler Ivani. This is a great time and play. Fanyan knows where he's going, sees the coverage, delivers the ball, and great diving catch there by Tyler Ivani. Great job.
Does look like an X-Men player is shaken up after that one. As the big man will make his way to the sideline. It's Will Chapman.
Not something you want to see when your offense is doing well with the deep ball and you have an elite running back. Because those both things. Now one thing is that the BU defense could get to the quarterback. Now you just lost one of your starting O linemen. I would expect Bishops to come with some pressure here on second and long.
A
Hot dog hamburger chips et friandises.
Second and 11 on the 34-yard line. Fagnan looking for a first down here for the X-Men. Brings in the snap. Being forced out of the pocket, a flag down on the play. Fagnan airing it out, sending it on into the crowd.
And what do we say? We saw pressure right off the jump. Look at Hawaii there right on the line. And then you'll see holding on 55, Rene Zivat. And Fagnan trying to make the most out of it. But now we're going to have a third down because the penalty will be declined. Holding on the X-Men.
And this game is presented to you once more by Bell. Get on Canada's best 5G network today. Visit bell.ca/5G. Is the punt team coming back out here? Is Capriotti shanking that one just a little bit as Hosang comes down with it. O'Shea Hosang with room, marching up to the BU logo.
Good return here by Hosang, putting the Gaiters in good field position on the 51. Now let's just see if the Gaiters can carry that momentum, but especially finish with the touchdown, because it's 7-7. But that's all scored by Gervais for the Gaiters versus X-Men's one touchdown.
Kirion with Briones in the backfield. Kirion reeling in the snap, play action, looking over towards Pierre Mass. He can't come down with it. A little high there for Pierre Mass.
Quick pass here to Pierre Mass, and look at who's covering him. Big 72, Dighton Blackett. Great job there on the coverage, did his job, and it's an incomplete pass for the Gaiters.
Second and 10 now. Kirion play action, jumping up in the pocket, dumps it off to Briones. Briones needing the room here. We'll see where they mark this.
It's close. It's close. Good job there by Kirion. Again, scrambling, but keeping the eyes down the field, finding an option. And it looks like they're just short. Now it's up to Coach Sheriff to see if he's going for it here. And we have McGriskin coming in. And last time McGriskin came out, we saw a jet sweep by Minosha, number 84. Let's see here what they do with the ball.
X-Men needed to line up a yard off the ball. McGriskin hopping up into the play. Looking for room as McGriskin gets a lot of yardage there.
Good job by McGriskin coming in and doing his job. Eight, right here in the shotgun, surprising the X-Men under center. Quick quarterback sneak and keeping the legs moving, getting a first down. And more importantly, hold it on to that ball. Gators crossing over into X-Men territory.
This will come back here, first and 10. Kirion making his way back out on the field. Chaloux joining him in the backfield for this drive. Ball handed off to Chaloux as he explodes upfield. A flag, though, however, comes out from the referee.
And it will be holding against the Gators. Here, Chaloux gets the ball. Finds the gap, gets the yards, but again, another penalty for the Gaiters, backing them up 10 yards.
As the Gaiters go back to center field here. We'll go back to first down, so first and 20. Chaloux and Kirion looking to make some magic happen. Kirion with a quick pass over to Lur, can't quite bring it in.
And that's one of those where it's so easy, it's hard. So here again, exploiting the X-Men's cover three. He knows that his hang route's going to be there. Gabin Lur just can't hold on to the ball. Tough drop there, making it a second and very long for the offense.
And so a second and 20 here on the 55-yard line. Kirillon drops back, it dumps it off to Chalou, and a quick hit there by the X-Men as the Gaiters go two and out.
Completed pass of 27.
Gaiters trying to do a running back screen here to Chalou, but just perfectly read by the middle linebacker for the X-Men, number 44, Josh Connors, stopping any progression here and forcing the punt team to come out.
So Guadfello come out to kick here for the Gaiters. Sending this one back. Obotimbe will return for the X-Men. A lot of room for Obotimbe as he broke free there.
On the punt number one, Yanni Guadfello. Return number two.
Obotimbe. Great return here by number two. Finding the crease and getting lots of yards on the return. Setting up the X-Men on their own 33.
And so the X-Men offense will come back out onto the field. Field General Silas Fanyan.
Now I'm curious to see here if we see Fanyan take another shot deep.
He'll hand the ball off to Bussey first. Bussey will dance around a couple defenders before being brought down.
Ball carrier number 27,
Gaiters front seven doing a great job
on the tackle, number five,
at holding Bussey to only a few yards per carry. Right here again, he's met right away, but he's hard to bring down, so make sure you got some backup coming in.
Second down.
Now we seem to have a second and about six for the X-Men.
Second and six on their own 37. Fanyan with Bussey. Play action as Fanyan dumps it off. Quick little pass there and a nice hit by McDonald.
And there's number 82, Zachary Ood. Seems to be a local because there's a lot of X-Men here cheering for him as soon as he caught the ball. And the name sounds very Quebecois. So great catch there. Good job holding on to the ball despite the tackle and the legs. And first down for the X-Men. I've got to say, the X-Men fans always travel extremely well. Every year, they probably had the best tailgate setup out of everybody today, giving out hot dogs, burgers.
It smelled really good walking in here to Coulter Field. As Fanyan airs this one out. Guadfell coming out of nowhere, batting it down. It looked like the Gaiters were going to come away with another pick.
And Fanyan, not shy at all to throw the ball down the field. But just three Gaiters there, triple coverage. But at the end of the day, he knows his guy. He's giving him a shot. And it wasn't even that far from being a catch. So good job there by the Gaiters.
So second and 10 now on the 44-yard line. See what the X-Men cook up here. And so now we'll get a timeout called here for St. Effects.
And Coulter Field is right next to some farmland, so we have a beautiful stench up here. And I know I'm not alone because I'm seeing the crowd right now waving away the smell. But welcome to Lenoxville. This is the swamp. The swamp amongst farmland.
Oh, yeah.
And it's been pungent and consistent for two quarters. I could not hold it in any longer. And we're back. Second and long. X-Men on the 44.
McDonald's. Fanyan looking to get a first down here for the X-Men. We'll see what he can do. As he brings the ball in, drops back in the pocket. He's met there by Zivat. Rene Zivat putting that one down. And so they'll call it an incomplete pass, actually.
And there he is, Big Z. Rene Zivat coming in with the pressure. And, ooh, I don't know about that. That could have been a fumble, but regardless, it was recovered by the X-Men. So that wouldn't have changed anything. But great job there by Zivat, putting some pressure on Fangin, because if he's comfortable, he can throw whatever he wants on the field. Now we have the punt team and Hosang ready to return.
We'll see if the Gaiters can bring the same pressure here as they do get to the backfield. Capriotti gets it up in the air. Hosang will reel it in for the Gaiters. They're jumping out towards the sidelines and gets put out of play.
And here's one thing that is underrated for punt returners, but when the punt is short, often you'll see players scared to really attack the ball and go catch the ball. But if you let it bounce, football's in odd shape. It'll bounce all around the place. So great hustle there by Hosang, getting underneath the ball and not letting it roll behind an extra 10, 15 yards. And just like that, the Gaiters take it at their own 30-yard line.
So the ref will whistle this one down. Saint Effects player tying his shoe here.
Gotta do that double knot.
As he makes his way back into the game.
That was nice. Give him time to tie his shoe. That's Canada right there. Canadian football, welcome.
Kirillon with a two-back set. Outside run there by Chalou as he gets wrapped up. Shoelace tackle by Josh Connors.
Two back set here was Hosang and Chalou. Hosang being the lead block. Chalou going on the wide run, but not getting much as he's met in the backfield, but he's able to stumble his way forward and get at least 3 yards for the purple and silver.
So we'll have a second and seven here on the 33-yard line. A play action faked everyone out there. Dumps it off to Chalou. Chalou gets taken down around the 40. We'll see where they spot this one.
That looks like a first down. And again, Kirillon, I'm praising him again for his patience. Nothing there, nothing there, nothing there. He's not scared to go to his outlet short there in the flat. And it is a first down for the Gaiters. Move them chains.
So we do got the 3-minute warning here. Saint Effects did defer after winning the toss, so they will receive the ball at the start of the second half.
If they pick to receive, which.
If they pick to receive, which. Kirillon now looking downfield over towards Griffith. Griffith. Hitting him in the chest there as he can't come away with it.
Kirillon just taking a shot deep to his veteran number 87, Brendan Griffith, but Brendan's got to reach out with his hands. He can't wait for the ball to hit his chest. What you say here, the receiving coaching point is highest point. You got to get the ball at its highest point. You got to jump up, put your hands up, try to get the ball, but unfortunately, Griffith taking a hit there too. A little slow to get up.
As Griffiths back up on his feet, a little shaken up after that one. He'll make his way off the field.
And I have no doubt that Brendan will be back in this game. He is tough as nails. And I believe next man up here is number 89, Nicolas Veillette, here at the wideout position.
We'll see what he can do. Get your number called. Make a play, guy. Carry on with Briones in the backfield. Kirillon drops back, jumps up, sends it over to Pierre Mas. Pierre Mas with a lot of room. So I have a first down for the Gaiters.
Pierre Mas just so quick coming across the field. Kirillon once again calm in the pocket, delivering the ball right in the numbers. And Pierre Mas just slippery, just slips off the tackles and able to get a first down for the Gaiters.
The Gaiters approaching us, well, at center field now as Kirillon wants to move the chains once more. Play action, finds an open target. Chaloux breaking a tackle and the chains keep on moving.
Great job here. Now, hopefully we see it in this replay, but keep your eyes on Chaloux at the slot at the top of your screen. Goes by the halfback, then he finds the zone. He stops, he doesn't stop running completely, but you can see that he finds the window. Him and his quarterback are on the same page. They both see the same thing. So he slowly settles down in the zone, gets a completion, and then he starts running again, puts his shoulder down, and it's a first down for the Gaiters.
Two back set. Kirillon faking the handoff. I'll just throw this one out of play. We'll have a flag down. See what it's for.
That was a very late hit. Let's see here. Kirillon gets rid of it, but there was no reason to finish that tackle. You can wrap him, yes, but you don't have to bring him all the way to the ground.
So the chains keep on moving. Down to the 20 now. Gaiters wanting points before going back into the locker room here. Back down to the 20. Last time they were here, they couldn't quite capitalize on the opportunity. Had to settle for three.
And you know, right now they're thinking touchdown. They don't want. They'll take the field goal, but that's not what they want here. They want that touchdown. Let's see what they do here.
Kirillon pass out. Brought down there by Nicolas Veillette.
There's Nicolas Veillette, next man up, making his first catch of the season, I believe. Even miscommunication there. Kirillon faking to the wrong side, but I'll put my money on the running back being the wrong side because he's a quarterback, he knows what he's doing. And the penalty seems to be against the X-Men, roughing the passer.
So we'll go down to the 1 yard line.
Curious to see here if the Gaiters bring in their big package with number 8, McGriskin. And Kirillon seems to be staying in. Just like that, two bad penalties by the X-Men. And the Gaiters are knocking on the door.
Still out, two back set.
Box is loaded.
Kirillon bobbles the snap. Gets brought down for a sack and out of the 10 yard line they go.
And that is the last thing you wanted to see. Number 94. If you're cheering for the purple and silver. Let's see if it was a bad snap. Not really, but the running back seemed to go in front of Kirillon just a bit. Maybe that was enough to get his eyes off the ball. Bobble the snap, and just like that, the Gaiters are on the 10.
So a second down here, second and 10 for the Gaiters. Kirillon with Briones and Chaloux. Looking to throw, sends it out towards the corner out. Burnett trying to come down with it, can't quite do
so. And there's a flag, there's a flag. There's pass interference against St. FX, I believe. And that's a great job by Burnett, because what do they say? If ever you can't get to the ball, still jump towards the ball, because you're going to draw a pass interference like it happened right there. It's PI against St. FX, giving the Gaiters a fresh set of downs, probably on the 1 yard line.
And they're not taking any chances no more as McGriskin comes out. So we'll see what they cook up here.
St. FX has a big front seven, so just running it up the gut isn't an automatic touchdown. But again, Canadian football, we have that 3 yard, so that makes it a lot harder on the defense to stop him here. McGriskin in the shotgun.
Faking a snap, coming up towards the line. McGriskin going with the Philadelphia Eagles special.
The tush push. And it's a touchdown for your Bishop's Gaiters. McGriskin in the shotgun saying, you know what? Let's go right underneath the snapper, get the ball, go wide. And it's a touchdown for your Bishop's Gaiters. Just like that, it's a 13-7 lead. Coulter Field is on its feet. And here comes the extra point team.
McGriskin turning on his inner Jalen Hurts right there, getting in the back of the end zone. And so Gervais will come back out for the PAT. Gervais looking to make it a 7-point game. As he chips this one up and through, so 14-7.
Extra point is good. Transformation réussie, number 12, de Pouze, Xavier Gervais.
Now I'm just looking at the clock right now. I'm seeing a minute 10. And a minute 10 is a ton of time, especially in Canadian football. Canadian football 101. If the clock still runs, it won't start until the referee blows the play in. In American football, if you do a run, you stop inbounds, the clock will keep running from the moment the play, it never ends basically. But in Canadian football, the clock will stop until the referee blows the whistle in. So that gives the team a lot of time to set up. And a minute 10 is a lot longer in this case.
As Gervais comes back out here to kick things back off.
And you just know that Fannin right now is salivating, knowing that they're going to throw it deep. They're going to go for a big play. Because that has been the weakness for the Gaiters so far on defense.
You got Udd as well as Harrington set to return here for the X-Men.
Yes, and I got some insiders texting me and informing me that Udd is indeed a local. He's from Tedford, right down the street. So that is why he has the big... Big
fan, the home
big
crowd.
Yeah, the home crowd here on the St. FX side. Right down the street, yeah.
As Harrington brings it in. Trying to escape a couple of tackles, it couldn't quite do so. So St. FX will start off at their own 19-yard line.
And I've got to say, the Gators special teams has been just on point today. As soon as the returner gets the ball, he is smothered by purple jerseys. And that right there is head coach Sheriff Nicholas and the special teams, first year special teams coordinator as well as head coach. But doing a great job there with punt blocks, field goal game is doing well, and the coverage teams is great.
So we'll see what Fannin is able to do here for St. FX, halting the count. Reels it in, a quick pass out towards the outside. That one brought in there by Ivani.
And here's another great example of the Gaiters defense being very quick with the tackles. The X-Men are catching the ball, but the Gaiters are extremely quick, not giving any extra yards.
Fannin dropping back again, rolling out of the pocket towards his right. Trying to look upfield, a couple pump fakes, lowering his shoulder and brought down there by the Gaiters. Shaking his head, saying no, there is Jet Wilson.
Fannin here, again, you love to see, keeping his eyes down the field, keeping the play alive, pump fake. But what you don't like, it scares me. Every time a quarterback puts his shoulder down and you have some big guys like that on defense hitting you, they're just salivating seeing you put your shoulder down. But I'm happy to see you walked off the field. He's fine. And now we have the Gaiters who are about to get the ball back with 44 seconds left. A lot of time left on the clock, and we have a timeout by Bishops.
And so Wilson coming away with a sack on that one. He actually leads the Gaiters with 3 sacks so far this season.
Jet Wilson, the FG player of the game last time we were out here on Coulter Field. Now St. FX has a great punter, but this is just close enough where you wonder if they even thought about giving the 2 points, but I don't think so. With 44 seconds left on the clock, I think they're going to trust their defense.
Capriotti here with a boot. Hosang letting it drop, but gains it off of the drop. Needs to protect this ball as Hosang tries to get out towards the right. Brought down right at center field there is O'Shea Hosang.
I mean, Hosang had nothing on that play. But the entire time he was staying up, you still thought, man, he might, oh, he might, he just breaks so many tackles and there's not much given to him, but he still finds a way to give you hope every time that he's going to take it long. But good job there by the X-Men's coverage, keeping him to just a few yards, and the Gators on the 54-yard line of the X-Men.
And so 31.6 left. Kirillon with Chaloux in the backfield. Kirillon handing the ball off. Chaloux now gaining some yards. First down here for the Gaiters. Down to the 30-yard line is a David Chaloux.
Now it's hurry up offense. Get back on the ball, but let's see this run first. Chaloux gets the ball, and a great job by the O-line here, giving him a high win. Then Chaloux does what he does best. He runs all the way down the field and puts his shoulder down, punishing the defenders trying to tackle him.
Now on the 30-yard line here for the Gaiters. First down for Bishops, 24 seconds left in the half. We'll see here as the refs will back it up. Going right on the whistle there, wasting no time as Bishops are dumping this one off. Brought in there by Charles-Édouard Bizier.
Great job there. There wasn't a lot of space, but Kirillon still tried to fit it in. And Bizier has great hands and was able to make the catch there. Pick up a five, un jeu de cinq
down. Going there once more, going quick. Looking end zone, here's Kirillon trying to find Burnett. Burnett comes down with it! Touchdown, Gaiters!
And Oliver Burnett! With the touchdown catch with 8 seconds left to go. He's running a corner and he's running it quick. Kirillon has the arm, gives him a shot. And look at Burnett. Oh no, we miss it on the replay, but it was a few inches off the ground. He caught it. And just like that, the Gaiters take the lead 20-7 in the 2023 Big Bowl.
The crowd is going crazy here. With 8 seconds left, Burnett reeling it in. 14-point lead for the Gaiters if Gervais puts this one through the uprights.
Burnett leading the entire conference with 3 coming into this game, 3 touchdowns, and now he has a 4th. Extremely happy for that young man. He's been working his tail off since day one, since he walked into Bishops at, I believe, 17 years old. Now he's a 5th-year just making play after play for the Gaiters.
As the Gaiters fight song coming onto the speakers here. The crowd singing along with it.
And you cannot ask for a better situation here for the Gaiters. Able to get the ball back with 44 seconds left and then drive down the field and even get a touchdown, not just points. I think they were going for at least a field goal after that run by Chaloux, but the fact that they're able to connect on a deep ball, Kirillon to Burnett once more. And just like that, they make it a 2-score game in the Big Bowl.
8 seconds left here in the half. Gervais running up a big boot over towards Harrington. Harrington bringing it in for St. FX, trying to make something happen as Harrington.
Yes. You got a block in
flag
the back.
On the play.
And who's that? Look who's making the tackle, number 11, Hosang. I told you, he's everywhere. He's on offense, he's on defense, he's on special teams. And just like that, it is the end of the first half.
Not yet.
Oh, I'm sorry.
There's a flag.
Oh, there is
down.
A flag, true. Flag on the play.
And so this will mark the end of the first half here as the Gaiters go into the locker room up 21-7 here in the Big Bowl. Our score at the half. An electric first half here. But the game is far from over.
Far from over, folks. Make sure to tune in the second half because it's going to be a good one.
And so we will now throw it. We will have a special guest after the break, however, so stay tuned for that, and we'll see you guys then.
We get it. We've been there.
We know how hard it is to be under pressure.
People are watching you and holding you accountable.
We know what it's like to be called out.
Expectations are set, and it's hard to even show up.
Whatever you do, don't let your guard down.
In these moments, we challenge you to rise up.
It's okay to crush a water.
Keep it social.
Excuse me. I had ordered a Pepsi Zero Sugar. Thank you. Pepsi Zero Sugar. Great taste, zero sugar. Taste the difference.
I dreamt we had cable internet.
Oh, sweetie. We've always had cable internet.
Once you're used to Bell Pure Fiber internet, anything else is terrifying.
Bishops is the huge community that we have here. It's super easy to get involved in like clubs and extracurriculars, and you get to meet so many people from different programs with different areas of interest, and you really get to be a part of a huge community.
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 I had to describe Bishops in one word. Community.
I was looking for a place with a really strong sense of like community and pride. Bishops totally has that.
I feel like this is where I'm meant to be.
When I walk to class every day, I know that I'm going to see at least half a dozen friends before I get to my first class. It puts me in a really great mood.
I chose to come to Bishops because something just clicked and it just felt right. Even though I'm a 10-hour plane ride from Sweden, Bishop feels like a new home to me. But don't tell my parents that.
This is a school where we know tradition and prestige. I mean, we've got plenty of red brick and ivy.
But we're also a different kind of university. Here, we're a family.
Here, we belong.
Here at Bishops,
we bleed purple.
And so welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Joining us is special guest Brian McNulty. How are you doing tonight?
Very good.
How's the game treated you so far?
Exciting night for you guys.
A very exciting night.
Oh, my goodness. You think you're going to hold on and win the
I hope goal? So. I hope so.
Okay,
I'll stay neutral, but I hope so. Yes. Could you give us a little insight on the big bowl? I know your family donated the bowl. Can you run us through the history of it a little bit?
That's right. I was born here in Sherbrooke a long time ago and then moved to Ottawa at the end of the Second World War and went to St. Effects.
Okay.
So I was, and then our daughter, Shannon McNulty, she ended up coming to Bishops and graduating in 2003. So there was that connection. Plus, my grandfather, who was Canon Big, was the Anglican minister at St. Peter's in Sherbrooke for about 25 years. but he was also connected to Bishops as sort of the padre of the at Bishops. So so there was that connection. Plus, and he had two daughters, one of whom worked here at Bishops for her lifetime, and the other who was my mother.
Yeah.
So there was that connection between Bishops and St. Avex in the family. And so in 2002, they started an interlocking schedule between the Quebec Conference and the Atlantic Conference. And I said, gee, it'd be nice if there was some sort of incentive during the middle of the season, you know, for like for Bishops and St. Avex when they played each other. And, of course, the history of both schools is that, like, Bishops, Anglican roots, and rural university, small university, liberal arts, and St. Avex, almost the same, Roman Catholic and roots in the country. So it was sort of a neat that the two universities were sort of same, which my daughter and myself attended, so that's we sort of... I got the idea, why don't we have a bowl, something nice, to present the winner of the game.
Yeah, that's awesome. And then, obviously, in 2017, Bishops moving over to the Atlantic Conference.
That's right.
So how has that really impacted this rivalry, I guess we can call it now, with the big bowl on the line
between
the two schools?
That's right. I think it's certainly helped. And the thing is that X is in the middle of a good cycle right now, their football.
A very good cycle.
And you guys are all of a sudden coming up, so it makes it really good. This is actually the ninth time the Big Bowl's been presented. And, you know, Bishops has won it twice. And if I'm supposed to be neutral, but if Bishops won it tonight, it'd be nice to make it a little closer.
On home turf, too. Bishops has won it twice, but they haven't won it here on Coulter Field yet.
That's all I didn't.
So it'll be very interesting to see here a big game, a lot of history behind the game too.
Yeah.
If you would have to pick a team to follow through, which team do you think you're siding with?
I'll tell you, I my wife likes purple. So I'll leave it at that.
That's awesome. We'll read into that.
Okay.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight, explaining a little bit about the Big Bowl, the history behind it. Thank you guys for donating
it. It's our pleasure.
And for really continuing with the little rivalry that we have going on here between St. Avex and Bishops and explaining the history behind the two schools.
Yep. Thank you very much.
So
Lightning.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us. It was a pleasure.
We get it. We've been there.
We know how hard it is to be under pressure.
People are watching you and holding you accountable.
We know what it's like to be called out.
Expectations are set, and it's hard to even show up.
Whatever you do, don't let your guard down.
In these moments, we challenge you to rise up.
It's okay to crush a water.
Keep it social.
Excuse me. I had ordered a Pepsi Zero Sugar. Thank you.
Pepsi Zero Sugar. Great taste, zero sugar. Taste the difference.
I dreamt we had cable internet.
Oh, sweetie. We've always had cable internet.
Once you're used to Bell Pure Fiber Internet, anything else is terrifying.
Bishops is the huge community that we have here. It's super easy to get involved in like clubs and extracurriculars, and you get to meet so many people from different programs with different areas of interest, and you really get to be a part of a huge community.
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 I had to describe Bishops in one word. Community.
I was looking for a place with a really strong sense of, like, community and pride. Bishops totally has that.
I feel like this is where I'm meant to be.
When I walk to class every day, I know that I'm going to see at least half a dozen friends before I get to my first class. It puts me in a really great mood.
I chose to come to Bishops because something just clicked, and it just felt right. Even though I'm a 10-hour plane ride from Sweden, Bishop feels like a new home to me. But don't tell my parents that.
This is a school where we know tradition and prestige. I mean, we've got plenty of red brick and ivy.
But we're also a different kind of university. Here, we're a family.
Here, we belong.
Here at Bishops,
we bleed purple.
And so back here, tonight's halftime score presented by Sherbrooke Record, St. Effects 7, Bishops Gaiters 21. As you see both captains out here, we'll see what St. Effects elects to do going into the second half. And so we'll see actually our halftime stats, which are presented to you by Bell. Get Pure Fiber, Canada's fastest internet technology. Check availability at bellalliant.ca/fiber.
Now, folks, let's look at that first line there. First downs. X-Men only have 3 first downs to Bishop's 16. That is huge. And speaking of time of possession, Bishop's has had close to 19 minutes of time of possession. St. Effects has barely had 11. So that's a big factor in the game. Bishop's is keeping possession of the ball. But now, again, they have their rushing game going on. 76 to St. Effects is 9. And they have the passing yards, 186. I'm surprised we haven't seen more of Fanyan, but what thing we've seen is that Fanyan can throw it deep, and now they're down 14 points. And this has got to be, I'm just guessing here, but I'm expecting this to be one of their biggest deficits so far in probably years for the X-Men. So I know that that halftime speech was very intense, and they definitely coming in with a different strategy for the second half. But one thing about the X-Men at the end of that half is that they shot themselves in the foot to... And pardon my French, but stupid rough in the passer penalties. That's self-inflicted wounds. You gave 30 free yards to the Gaiters in the red zone, putting them at the 1 after the Gaiters shot themselves in the foot, getting a sack and backing up to the 10. So mental mistakes. both teams here know that they could score, but and they can score fast. So I'm expecting a great second half with more big moments, big hits, and big plays, because it's the Big Bowl, baby.
And this bowl means so much here to the Bishops community. I was actually speaking to athletic director Matt McLean, Matt McBrien, excuse me, and he came up into the booth, and he looked super nervous. He goes, these are going to be the two longest quarters of the season for him, just wanting to have the bowl here in Lenoxville. As we'll see what Gervais can do off of the kickoff, how Fanyan comes out here to start off the second half.
And it's not the playoffs, but winning a bowl game is just special. And for me, from my 5 years at Bishops, that win was probably, it was one of the top three, one of the most special wins that we've had here at Bishops. So excited to hear that the Gaiters could potentially do this on a home field, but the game's far from done yet.
And they'll make history as they've never won here on home field, the Big Bowl. As Harrington brings it in for St. Effects, as he's wrapped up and brought down.
And we've talked about the proficiency of the special teams here. As soon as the returner gets the ball, there's not much that he can do. The special teams are doing great, whether it's on kickoff or punt. Even on punt, they give the 5-yard halo. We haven't seen those penalties. We saw a lot in the first few games. We haven't seen any yet from the Gaiters, but their coverage has been great. Just their overall defense, their tackling is very good and very safe for the BU Gaiters.
As Silas Fanyan will be in the backfield with Bussey. The temperature has dropped here. You gotta love Canadian weather as Bussey moves out towards the outside, gets wrapped up. Once more, he's having himself a night as Christopher Kramer on the tackle.
Tackle number 51,
good job here. We see the two lead blocks there on the line. Bussey getting past the line of scrimmage, but not much more. Good job again for the Gaiters, securing the tackle, not going for the big hit, going for the safe hit, bringing him down to the ground.
Fanyan with Bussey once more, second and six now on the 26-yard line. Fanyan dropping back, feeling the pressure here by the Gaiters, and moving up into the pocket, trying to take it himself. Gets wrapped up on the tackle.
Fanyan here, good job making something out of nothing, getting some yards, not enough for the first down, but running away from pressure, and oh my God, there's just so many people after him. He needs more time to throw the ball. I don't know, that might have been a little bit of a coverage sack though, because that did take a lot of time. He wasn't that rushed, but as soon as he decided to scramble, there was just nowhere to go for the quarterback. And we've seen a lot of punts being short here, so expect Hostline to maybe move up a little bit.
As Capriotti gets this one up and underway. Hosang taking it down for the Gaiters. Up trying to get to the 50-yard line. Couldn't quite do so as he gets brought out of bounds.
The return number 11 to Halls, O'Shea Hosang.
So coming back out on the field, number 9, Justin Quirion. So far this game, he is 18 for 25 on the passing game for a total of... And there it is. He's 18 for 25, 186, one touchdown to Mr. Oliver Burnett. But right now leading in terms of passing yards is Nicolas Pierre-Mass with 57 for the Gaiters.
As Quirion is in the backfield with Chalou, trips out to Quirion's left. Tight end on the line as Chalou brings it in. He'll try to gain a couple yards, and he's met right in the trenches. Only a 2-yard gain on that one.
Great job here by the X-Men's front seven, not giving anything here to the running back. As soon as he gets the ball and gets the line of scrimmage, he's met by two X-Men, nowhere to go. And now we have second and long for Bishops.
Second and long here for the Gaiters. Quirion taking his time as he brings in the snap. Hands it off to Chalou once more. Chalou breaking free. First down, Gaiters. As Chalou makes it up to the 45-yard line.
And I've sang my praise about Chalou, but what about this O-line? I absolutely love this O-line here by the Gaiters, always giving their running backs a fair shot here and making a big play. And led by number 66, Olivier Fournier, he was a walk-on his first year with Bishops, But ever since he walked on, he's been a five-year starter and now a team captain. So shout out to you, Olivier Fournier. We never talk about the O-line enough, but they've been doing an amazing job protecting their quarterbacks and giving lanes to their running backs.
As Kirillon brings it in, dropping back, looking to pass over to Griffiths.
I'm glad to see Griffith is back here. And again, here we're exploiting the cover three by the same effects X-Men. Look at the top of your screen. You can't even see the corner here. So then Griffith is going to settle down in that zone, catch the ball, and just get the yards that are given to you.
So a five-yard gain there for Bishop. Second and five on the 40-yard line.
And again, that arm strength by Kirillon helps a lot there, because even though it's a five-yard pass, in the air it's probably more 25 to 30. So the fact that he could get that ball quick makes it a lot easier on the receiver.
Kirillon brings in the snap, hands it off to Briones. Briones now met at the line of scrimmage and stopped short there on second down is Marco Briones.
Great job here by Saint Effect, stuffing Briones at the line. You see here, Briones had a few lead blockers, but just bodies on the ground at the line of scrimmage, nowhere to go, gets tangled up, and here comes the punt team.
Gervais is out here for the punt team. And he gains possession as Gervais with another onside kick as Briones looks to run onto that one. You saw it earlier on in the season. The Gaiters were unsuccessful on this time.
Yeah, so Gervais is basically here as one of the backs for protection, protecting the punter, but direct snap and just shanked the punt there. That's the distance he was going for, but just not the location. You want it to stay inbounds, and what's great is that whoever is behind the guy who punts can go get the ball, which we've seen the Gaiters be successful once, just not on this try.
As Fanyan will come back out on the field. Fanyan airing this one out. He finds Zach Ood.
Zach Ood from right down the street at Tefer Mines. Zachary Ood. And what we're seeing here is we're seeing the X-Men bringing extra protection here with their big guy, number 80, Jack True, coming in to aid in the protection. He's a tight end, but sometimes you'll see him slide in and right in the middle. That's where they're most vulnerable on the O-line. So he comes in and he adds to that protection, giving Fanyan a lot more time and a lot more comfort throwing the ball.
Second and short now for Fanyan as he hands the ball off to Bussey. Fanyan sending out a block on Royer. Ball carrier
and the X-Men are coming out in the second half, and they're hungry. This is the first time we've seen Bussey actually get some type of daylight. And look at Fanyan, giving a block for his guy against none other than Gab Royer. Scary thing to see your quarterback do, but that just shows the dog in him. He's here, and he wants to win. He wants it bad.
Fanyan back in the backfield with Bussey. First down now for the X-Men. Dropping back is Fanyan. Sends this one out. Can't bring it down as Devon Blackwood.
This is a very tough catch. The ball was right there on the money, but that's tough because look at your halfback here coming straight for number seven. And it's hard as a receiver because you're looking at the ball, but at the corner of your eye, you see that purple jersey coming in full tilt. And that was just enough to make him drop the ball.
So now second and 10 on the 53-yard line. Fanyan with a lot of time airs this one out over to Blackwood. And Blackwood with the reception, making a couple players miss. Down to the 15-yard line is Devon Blackwood, making up for his mistake.
And there you go, just like that, Blackwood redeeming himself here. Again, we had True, number 80, adding to the protection, giving Fanyan some extra time and giving him plenty of time to throw it down the field. Blackwood making a catch and making a few guys miss. And just like that, St. FX has the ball on the Gators' 13-yard line.
So first and 10 here in the red zone for the X-Men. Bussey getting his number called as he brings it on down. another first down here for the X-Men.
Bussy here getting a lot more breathing room so far in the second half. And he's very dangerous with the ball if you give him some space. Just like that, hard to bring down, but they're able to bring him down at the 2 yard line. And it's a first down at the Gator 2.
So first and goal here for the X-Men. We'll see what they come out and do as they bring their big men on the field here.
Yeah, and I believe we're going to have a flag for too many men on the field. And that's a costly penalty there when you're on the 2 yard line.
Too many men in the huddle on FX.
They had their big package. They had linebackers. They had D-linemen in that backfield. But now I believe they're going back to their regular personnel, going back 5 yards.
So first and goal once more here inside the 10-yard line.
And again, lots of room to work with in these Canadian end zones. 20 yards, that's twice the size as the American end zones, giving Fannin a lot of room for his receivers to run routes down the field.
Fannin handing this one off to Bussy. Bussy dancing around a couple players as he gets inside the five.
Great job there by the front seven, stopping Bussy short. And it seems like we do have a man down for the X-Men.
Brandon James, Poulin Marquez.
Brandon James, Poulin Marquez are coming up with the tackle. Four names on that one.
I'm just going to guess here that that's another Quebecois there looking at the last name. Now, this is big because. Unfortunate injury, but this gives a lot of time for the X-Men offense right now. They're with their quarterback on the sideline, game planning on what's Fannin's favorite play here. What's he prefer here in this field? We're at 5 yards from the end zone. I'm curious to see here, do we go pass, do we go run? I'm leaning towards pass. Why? Because the Gators have been very good at stopping Bussy quick, and they just lost one of their big men up front. So I'm expecting a quick catch and throw here by Fannin, probably to one of his favorite targets. One person that's missing in action is, I believe, Zachariah Kareem, number 88, the second leading receiver for the X-Men, not playing today, did not make the trip.
As we'll come back out here, second and goal on the 5 yard line.
And here comes Fannin. We got 10 seconds left on the clock. They gotta act quick. I don't think they're gonna wanna waste the timeout here. 5, 3, right on time.
Fannin brings it in, play action, making a couple defenders dance. A flag down in the back of the end zone.
Ball carrier number 13, and the ties. So the ball is Silas Fannin.
That's as soon as Fannin drops back, he's met with a lot of pressure. And it, from my angle, looked like the ball came out, but there is a penalty. Let's see who it's against. And it's illegal contact on the Gators. Brutal penalty here in the red zone after stopping them. And I believe we have the big personnel for the X-Men coming in.
Just shooting themselves in the foot there are the Gators. And so we'll have a first and goal here on the 2 yard line.
Yep, the Gators paying back the favor. The X-Men earlier did the exact same thing, taking costly penalties in their own red zone. Now the Gators doing the same here, giving the X-Men the ball on the 2 yard line. And
is forced to take a timeout here.
Fannin not happy at all. I don't know what's going on here, but this package seems like it's all over the place. They had an extra man earlier on the big package. Now they seem to have everybody they wanted, but Fannin calls the timeout.
Looks like they were missing a player.
can't happen here in the red zone. And that timeout, that's going to be huge in this game. First half, waste of timeout. Okay, stinks, but you can live with it. In the second half, however, that timeout could be massive at the end of the game. So the fact that they're only left with one makes it a lot tougher if they need a last-minute drive. Let's see what they come up with on first down.
As Fanyan will rejoin the huddle here. Still first and goal for the X-Men.
Now we see their big personnel. When you see numbers like 52 in the backfield, they're trying to pound the rock.
Fanyan exploding through there.
Like butter, Fanyan finding the crease and just walking into the end zone. Look here on your right. Finds the hole, and great job there by the veteran quarterback getting 6 points for his team.
And so they'll look to make the game a one-score game. As Hadley comes out here for the X-Men. Puts that one up and through.
Extra point is good.
And just like that, it's 21-14 for the Bishop's Gaiters. We're about to return the kickoff next. Now, one thing we saw so far in the second half is that the run game for the X-Men is starting to work. Bussy is getting a lot more room with his running game, and it's making it a lot easier for him. And what happens is that now the run game is a threat. So you got to adjust the defense for the run game, which opens up the pass game. So this game is far from over, folks. There's a lot to happen. But let's see here what the Gaiters do on offense.
A lot of football left to be played here.
3-4-5. 5-2-8. 3-4-5.
As Hadley comes out.
For $305. 5-2-8-3-4-5. If you have that number, come see us. The press box.
Hadley putting this one up towards Hosang. Hosang reel it in for the Gaiters. Hosang still on his feet, still marching away, gets up towards the 25-yard line.
On the return, number 11, the almost O'Shea Hosang.
So hard to bring down, giving the Gaiters good field position after a great kick. Corner of the field on like the 2 yard line. That's a great kick there by Hadley. But good return by Hosang, giving the Gaiters good field position here on their 24 yard line.
Congratulations to our winner.
Kirion was in there. Kirion in the backfield with a Chaloux and Briones. Trips out to his right. Hand off over to Chaloux. Chaloux jumping right up the gut.
Ball carrier number 27.
Chaloux here taking the ball, going towards his left, and there was a crease there, but as soon as he got through it, the linebackers were there ready to meet him, and he did not get an inch once he was touched.
So second and seven here for Kirion, the Gaiters.
Pick up a four.
Halting the count on that one.
Second down.
On their own 27-yard line. Kirion brings it in, decides to roll out of the pocket. The lefty over towards Pierre Mass. It's caught, but there is a flag on the play.
And it's a holding against the Gaiters. Great job there by Kirion. Finding someone down the field. Pierre Mass coming across the field. But just an unfortunate penalty again by Bishops, putting them in a second and very long.
Holding the call on Bishops.
St. Effects gaining momentum here in the second half. They just scored on offense, forcing the Gaiters back here for a second and long. Trying to do it on both ends of the ball.
Now, this is an area here where, yes, you do want the first down, but you don't want to go too risky with the play because you are close to your end zone.
As Kirillon drops back, met by a lot of pressure. Pass batted down there.
Let's see here. Great job by the D lineman doing what? Not getting the sack, but being able to put your hands up and batting the ball down and disrupting the play there, forcing the third down. Gaiters backed up. Gwadfeld's going to have to punt this near his own end zone. And that's where you're thankful having a punter who has a boot because... And now we have a timeout for Bishops. And again, that was a personnel issue. We've seen it on both sides of the ball. Both teams wasting a timeout because of personnel. You hate to see that. One thing you'll see is the practice before the game. Part of the practice is just calling out personnel. You're not even running plays. You're just calling out personnel to come on the field. Count it. We have 12 guys. Good. Call the other set of personnel. So they actually practice this to make sure this doesn't happen. And now it's happened to both teams.
As we'll see what Gwadfeld decides to do here for the Gaiters. Awaiting the snap is Yanni Gwadfeld. As he runs and puts this one up, he's trying to get onto it himself.
I have no idea what just happened there. I don't know if there was pressure, if he was worried, if that was a planned onside kick. If it was, why would you do that so close to your end zone? St. FX already had the momentum, and now you just gave them momentum with a penalty. And now great field position. Now they're on the Gators 38, and they got all the momentum going their way, and now they could potentially tie the game here in the third quarter with 4 minutes left, almost five.
As Fanyan comes back out on the field here, just got a rushing touchdown as he'll come out with a play action on the receiving end of a big hit there. Kramer in the backfield once more.
Christopher Kramer reminding Fanyan that he's still out here. And great job, Rene Zivat just going straight for the running back. Good job on the run fake, but Kramer just laying the hammer down on Fanyan just enough to take the ball off target. And now what are we looking at? We're on the 38. If the X-Men don't get any yards here, they might still be in range for their kicker. We'd be at 45 yards.
High snap brought down by Fanyan. Fanyan airing this one out, bobbling it as it's incomplete there to Blackwood.
That's a tough drop there by Blackwood. Fanyan, not the best ball, but giving his receiver a chance, and it was right in his hands, just not able to make the catch. And now I believe we're going to see the X factor I said earlier for the X-Men, Ben Hadley. He's done a 45-yard kick, and we are right at 45 yards here on the right hash. Not that much wind. This is a kick that he can make. This would bring the game within one score for the X-Men.
We'll see what Hadley has here. Puts this one up and straight through.
That's a great kick. Ben Hadley, another 45-yard field goal. Great job there by the kicker, putting up 3 points for his team. And right there, again, I'm coming back to that punt. I don't know what happened on the punt for the Gaiters, but it gave the X-Men great field position. And just like that, they were within field goal range without getting a single yard.
As the X-Men are just inching their way back into this game. I mean, they're still in it, 21-17.
Listen, there's 3:42 less in the third quarter. Left in the third quarter. There's tons of game to be played here. And so far, the second half has been all about the X-Men.
We'll see what Kerryon can do now as O'Shea is in the backfield with him. Kerryon back out to Lur. Lur cutting inside. And we'll gain a first down here.
And good job here. We've said it multiple times. They like going to that outside receiver on cover three. Gives him a lot of space, and just like that, we're moving the chains for the Gaiters.
First down, the Gaiters now. Halting the snap call there is Kerryon. Kerryon play action, a quick pass out. And a lot of room here. Downfield is Bizier.
And great job there. And just like that, Kerryon crosses the 200-yard passing yards for the game once again this season. Now let's see here the great play by Kerryon, but even better play by Biz, number 18, Bizier. Let's see the catch here, slipping off a tackle and then going upfield. And then turning on the Jets. Great job there. Gaiters. Getting way more than a first down and putting the Gaiters on the 27-yard line.
Kerryon now set to take in the snap. In the backfield with Hosang. Kerryon quick pass towards the outside. Brought down and more room. A flag though in the backfield.
Complete a pass to number 89. Pass complete to 89. Nicolas Veillette. Tackle number 9. Le Neuf. Chris Lemoine.
Great job there by Veillette getting a lot of extra yards after the catch. However, there is a flag and it does seem to be a holding against Bishops.
Man down for St. FX is Thomas Bentley.
Kerryon here, definitely not happy with his team, knowing they've been shooting themselves in the foot this entire second half. Every time they get a big play, the momentum is killed by stupid penalties. And it's not a holding, it's a hands to the face. And that is a 15-yarder. Now we're looking at a first and very long. Just like that, they went from the X-Men's 27 to the, it's a 10-yard penalty, to the 37.
So we'll see what they can do here.
And Gaiters showing they can move the ball at will, but can't seem to do so without getting penalties.
Just over 2 minutes left in the third quarter. Gaiters leading by 4. Kerryon taking in the snap, a play action. Same call, sends it out to Veillette. Veillette makes a defender miss once more as he gets back up to the original line of scrimmage.
Great job by Veillette. Again, the Gaiters exploiting that cover three by the X-Men. But look at Veillette here. I love this play. Catches the ball, slips off one tackler, switches the ball hands. He's protecting the ball, putting it towards the sideline. And then you see that, the little stretch at the end? That's what got them the first down here. Great job. Not the first down, sorry. I forgot we backed up 10. So now it's second and 10 for the Gaiters.
Back at the original line of scrimmage here after the 10-yard gain. Kerryon facing a lot of pressure under this one. Airing it out, trying to send it off to Lur. Just off the mark there.
Just off the mark there, and now, quick math, we're on the 27. It'll be a 34-yard field goal, I believe, for Xavier Gervais. He's done a 35, he's missed a 34, and now he has another shot at the 34 here on the left hash. This is big here because this makes it a one touchdown game if he gets it here.
Massa set here. Looking back at his kicker. Everything's ready as Gervais puts this one up.
And the kick is good.
Through the uprights.
Great kick there by Gervais. It was actually 35 yards, and he gets it again. Now the Gaiters are up 24-17 with 57 seconds left in the third quarter of this year's Big Bowl matchup. Gaiters here happy to come out with some points, but again, more penalties. Stopping some big plays here. They're now at 6 penalties for 52 yards. Doesn't seem like a lot of yards, but a lot of those penalties were on first downs or giving St. Effects a first down. So very costly penalties here.
And so the X-Men make their way back out of the huddle is Fanyan with Bussey. Play action. Fanyan looking downfield. Looking to be brought down. Sends this one up and out of play.
And great job here getting pressure on the quarterback. Fanyan rolling out. I believe that was number 35. Samuel Robichaud, the Bishop's Gaiters, getting pressure on the quarterback. And this is what's tough with Canadian football. With three downs, you have one incompletion. You're looking at second and long. It's tough. Second and long is a tough down, but this X-Men offense is built to go long. So let's see what they do here. Fake count.
Fanyan with a lot of pressure. Scooped up, we'll see.
And it seems to be tipped and intercepted. Let's see here if we could see it on the replay. Great pressure here by the Gaiters, putting their arms up, getting the tip, and we can't see it here, but let's just trust the refs that it's an interception, and the Gaiters get the ball at the 35-yard line.
Royer coming up with the pick. That'll be his third of the season.
Again, we talked about Royer. He is just a disruptor on defense, whether it's against the run plays and the pass plays. He's just everywhere all the time, and now he has three interceptions on the season, tying his teammate for number one in the conference with three interceptions this year.
As we'll see here at Kirion, set with Chaloux. Play action, Kirion under pressure, now rolling out to his left. Kirion seems to have been cramping up there. Yeah, it looks like his calf was cramping up. Not really the explosiveness that he normally has out of the backfield.
Good timing here being the end of the third quarter.
And so we will send it on into commercials here. 24-17 going into the fourth. Next in action right here on Coulter Field on Friday.
What's wrong?
I dreamt we had cable internet.
Oh, sweetie. We've always had cable internet.
Once you're used to Bell Pure Fiber internet, anything else is terrifying.
Kirion back up to his feet, making his way off the field. He'll have to take a three-play break here as McGriskin coming back out onto the field for the Gaiters.
Now the Gaiters here in good field position. They're one first down away from a sure shot here by Gervais for a field goal. Now let's see if the number 8, McGriskin, can manage this offense for a few plays.
And once more, this game is presented to you by Bell. Get Pure Fiber, Canada's fastest internet technology. Check availability at bellalliant.ca/fiber. As we put our fours up, ready for the fourth quarter here. And the temperature has dropped here on Coulter Field. I'm zipping up my jacket.
And here comes McGriskin.
McGriskin keeping it himself. Up the field, Mason McGriskin dropping his shoulder. One more to beat as he's brought down, Mason McGriskin.
Nathan McGriskin said, Kirion, take a few plays off. I got it from here. Keeps the ball, goes right up the gut, and puts his shoulder down. Makes the defender lose his helmet and gets some more yards. Great play here, but there is laundry on the field.
We'll see what the call is here. And it looks like we're going backwards.
Objectionable conduct against the Gaiters.
After the play, so we'll still get a first down. We're getting word that it was probably from his celebration there. He did flex towards the crowd. It didn't look like he did much, but
McGriskin being
enough.
A bad sport there, yelling and flexing his arms, keeping them to his side, but can't be too happy when you make a big play like that, apparently.
As McGriskin now reels in the snap. He's set to throw this time. Sending the ball out. Burnett can't quite reel it in.
McGriskin here showing the arm talent. Seeing Burnett. Burnett was there, but couldn't close in on the catch. And now we have a second and long for the Gaiters. And I believe this will be the last play where Kirion must stay off the field. And I'm trying, but I cannot see that far. I'm trying to see if he's ready to get back on.
As we have McGriskin now keeping it himself. Back up is McGriskin. Down at the 25-yard line, so decent gain there.
I believe it won't be a first down here, but look at this run by McGriskin with a dual threat, faking it to Shailu, and just running it up the gut here, and that O-lineman, 61, he's got to go get his block. He was too passive there, waiting for the defender to come to him. He's got to go towards the defender and give his running back, quarterback, a shot at the run there, but good job by McGriskin getting some good yards and making it a much easier field goal for Gervais. Gervais having a big workload today.
As Gervais puts this one up and wide.
Field goal attempt missed from 24 yards.
And it's a missed field goal by Gervais getting the rouge, which makes it a 25-17 game.
8-point game here on Coulter Field.
Mixed emotions here, seeing the starting quarterback go off the field, but seeing the backup getting some great plays using his legs. Now we're back to the other starting quarterback, number 13, Mr. Fangan. Ready to lead this X-Men offense, hopefully towards some more points for the St. FX.
Silas Fanyan with Bussey in the backfield. Fanyan, a quick pass out to Ud. Jumping up on that one was Gwedfell.
The design screenplay here, fake to Bussey and turned right away towards her receiver, quick pass. Let's see the blocks here by the receivers. Not much. The Gators able to get there, but not until the receiver got 6 yards, making it a 2nd and 4 for the visiting team.
So 2nd and 4 on the 41-yard line for the X-Men. Fanyan, another play action out to Ud once more. Ud with room as Gwedfell tries punching that ball out.
Great pass, great catch, and great run after the catch by Ud there. Catching the ball in the flat and then turning on the Jets. Able to get another 10 to 15 yards. And the X-Men crossing over to the Gator side of the field.
Fanyan having a conversation with his line here. Hand off to Bussey. Bussey trying to cut back upfield. Met there by the Gators D-line.
That looked a lot more like the defense we saw in the first half. Stopping Bussey as soon as he gets the ball. Let's see here again. Number five disrupting the play in the backfield. Finishing the tackle for his defense.
Loss of one.
And so we'll have a second and long situation on their own, on the opposing 48-yard line here for the X-Men. Fanyan dropping back, airing it out to Ud. Ud with a beautiful reception there for being forced out of bounds.
Zachary Ud here with the stick. He's one-handed catch for the first down. Fanyan there, great ball, and then whoop. One-handed catch there by Ud gets the first down, keeps the drive alive, and the chains moving.
As we'll see here what Fanyan could do. Bussey in the backfield with him. He motions out Fanyan, dropping back. Quick pass out to Harrington there.
And one thing we're seeing now, look at number 80 at the top of your screen behind the line, adding himself to the protection, giving Fanyan some extra protection there from the Gators, giving him more time to throw the ball, more comfort in that pocket. Jack True playing a huge role here in the passing game, even though he's not the one running the routes.
So we'll get the play back underway here with Fanyan. Fanyan looking downfield and brought in by Blackwood.
Completed pass number seven, not hard to set. Devon Blackwood.
Great job here by Fanyan. Able to read the defense, 15, find the gap in the defense, and throwing it right to his receiver, Blackwood, who's making the catch. Good job there, getting another first down, and the X-Men are marching down the field quite easily. And let's not forget, this is an 8-point game. If they get a 2-pointer, this is a tie ball game.
Fanyan with Bussey. New set of downs. They're still looking to throw the ball. Fanyan jumping up in the pocket. He's being chased down by some Gators. Staying on his feet. Still spinning. Focus free!
He was not down. Jesus. Fanyan spinning over and over and over. Let's see here if we could see anything on the replay. They're saying it's X-Men ball.
Tackle
number 35, Samuel Let's see here. Hopefully I'm wrong and the refs are right. And we don't have time here for the replay.
As the big boys come back out here for the X-Men. Fanyan will jump up, a flag down.
Flag on the play, Maxence Lejeune.
Gonna see here if we could go back on the previous play and see here Fanyan spinning once, spinning twice, spinning three times, and let's see the ball.
That's a close one right there.
And it seems that it is a touchdown for the X-Men on the previous play. It was a flag on the Gators, which is declined, and it is touchdown for the X-Men, and now it's a 2-point ball game. And it has been all about Saint effects in this second half. Gators up 14, and that lead is now down to 2.
As the offense does stay out on the field here for the X-Men.
Picking to run their play from the left hash. We have regular personnel.
Fanyan with Bussey. Looking to throw there. over towards Blackwood. A beautiful ball there as Blackwood comes down with it.
That's a great catch by Blackwood, but even better ball by Fanyan. Let's see it here on the replay. Well covered. Slight push, but Blackwood makes the catch. And just like that, folks, it's a 25-25 game here for the Big Bowl matchup.
25. As the Gators offense will make their way back out onto the field after this kickoff.
Now the Gators here looking for some type of momentum in the second half. They saw some with McGriskin, but now the question is, who's coming in at quarterback? Is it number 9 or number 8?
Does look like McGriskin's ready to go there on the sideline, helmet on and everything, and I still don't see Kirillon. There's a little squib kick all the way up at Hosang. O'Shea Hosang with room, looking to jump over yet another player there. As McGriskin will make his way out back out onto the field.
Now McGriskin is a different game plan than when you have Kirillon. And Kirillon is more of the knowing exactly where to go, catch and throw type of guy. McGriskin is more of a wild card because he could use his legs as much as he can use his arm. But he does have a great arm, so I wouldn't be surprised if we see the ball down the field.
McGriskin reeling it in. Hand off to Chaloux. Chaloux coming upfield, being brought down here by the X-Men.
Great job by the X-Men here, stuffing Chaloux.
Oh no. Chaloux cramping up this time now.
And it has been a short week. We have a game on a Friday. Both these teams played on Saturday. So both of these teams are coming off a short week. What does that mean? The body's not as fresh as it usually would be. You don't have as many recovery days. And you probably had practice yesterday to make up for the short week. So I'm not surprised we're seeing players cramping up here because short week makes a big difference in the sport of football.
And if you want to keep in action with both teams, Week 7 football action on AUS TV, Saturday, October 2nd, Acadia travels down to St. Effects. It's a 2 p.m. Atlantic time kickoff. As for Bishops, once more on Saturday, next Saturday, October 7th, they travel down to St. Mary's, 3 p.m. Atlantic time, 2 p.m. Eastern, meaning that Mount Allison will have a bye on Canadian Thanksgiving weekend. St. Effects sideline is being loud here. As McGriskin hands it off to Hosang. Hosang cutting up field, good enough for a first down. Moving the chains are the Gators.
Great job here, just so many running threats on the Gators offense. Hands it off to number 11, cutting up the field. And Hosang is very patient when he runs with the ball. He's not in a hurry to cut up field. He's going to read the defense, read his blocks, but he's very smart with the ball, and you saw it here on first down.
So first and 10 on the 41-yard line. McGriskin bringing in the snap. Hands off to Briones. Briones flipping forwards. We'll see where he gets marked here.
Tackle number 44 to count. Josh Connors.
A 3-yard gain under that one. Second and 7 now. Still two backs in the backfield. McGriskin faking that one, taking it himself upfield. He gets stopped short. very short.
On the rush, number eight, Mason McGriskin.
McGriskin here faking it to the running back, trying to get the running back to act as a lead block for him, but just met with a pile of defenders there. And the Gaiters are short. Now, we mentioned it earlier, but those points, those missed field goals, and that long field goal by Hadley, by the X-Men, those kickers have a huge role to play. We have a few rouges instead of field goals for the Gaiters and a very long field goal by the X-Men. And now look at it, we have a 25-25 game. Those points are always extremely important.
We'll see what Grudfeld can do here. Doesn't quite get under that one there, is it, Grudfeld? As Harrington cutting out towards the outside, a lot of room, a flag down. Beautiful throw there by the referee on the flag. Not often you see your punter making an aggressive tackle like that.
And I'm assuming just by where the flag was thrown that it will be a holding on the X-Men. And that will back them up 10 yards. X-Men here have had all the momentum in the second half, trying to finally take their first lead of the game.
Since the first quarter, since the game was 7-4, St. FX. As Fanyan will come out onto the field with Bussey. High snap brought in. Fanyan rolling out of the pocket. Tip ball. Nobody there for the Gaiters.
That's a dangerous tip right there. Lucky there's no one behind that. But Fanyan, as soon as he gets the ball, fakes it to the running back and rolls out, gets away from the pressure and gives his receiver a chance. But the receiver drops a tough catch. That's a tough catch, though. But the ball after that pops up in the air. And lucky for the X-Men that there was no purple jerseys there to catch it. Now, one thing's for sure is that if ever the X-Men have to punt, there is no way they will give 2 points here.
Fanyan in the backfield now. Lone quick pass out. Gaiters can't quite wrap up, and so we'll have a St. FX first down on that one.
Completed pass.
Zach Ood.
Great throwing catch here by the X-Men. As soon as it's caught. Couple missed tackles here by the Gaiters, very costly, giving Ood lots of room to get more yards than required.
As we'll get a first and 10 here on the 36-yard line. Under 5 left in today's event. Fanyan play action, rolling out again, rolling to his right. Dumps it off and a big hit there by Jet Wilson.
Not much there for the quarterback. Still able to get the ball off, get the completion. And the quick hit there by Jet Wilson, making it a 2nd and 6 for the X-Men.
Second and 6 now on the 40 for Fanyan. Bussey once more in the backfield with him. Gaiters have been able to get pressure here on Fanyan. We'll see if they're successful forcing him out of the pocket. He takes it himself, exploding through the middle. We'll see if he reached forward enough. Looks like he was just short.
And it is third down. This is a tough call here because you're near midfield, and we're going to bring out the punt team. We have 4 minutes 25 left in the game. But if I'm on the Gaiters bench, I'm yelling, watch the fake, because this is prime fake punt area right here when you're near midfield like this.
Hosang makes his way back out. Capriotti out for the X-Men.
Seems to be
the X-Men taking a flag here. They miss personnel at a costly time in today's game.
That will eliminate the risk of a, well, never say never, but makes the fake punt much less probable. And we even see the personnel change from the Gaiters, so I don't think I was the only one thinking fake punt here.
We'll see here what Capriotti does. The Gaiters bring in a bunch of pressure as Capriotti gets that one off. Hosang backing up on his heels. Reels it down. Hosang trying to come upfield, slipping on that one, and he's brought down inside the 25-yard line.
Great punt here. Great coverage by the X-Men, not giving Hosang anything there on the punt return.
Tackle number 15, Le 15, Joe Hancock.
And here come the Gators offense.
55 yards on that last kick.
And it is led by number 8, Mr. McGriskin. Let's see, he has less than 4 minutes to go here in this game, trying to lead the Gators to a Big Bowl win.
So McGriskin brings it down, pass out towards Burnett.
Great catch there. Great catch there by Burnett. Not the easiest catch, but able to extend here. McGriskin again has a cannon of an arm. You can see it here. Quick ball, Burnett on his knees, but still making the catch. Now a second and short for the offense.
Second and two to go here for the Gators on their own 32-yard line. McGriskin with Briones. McGriskin keeping it himself and needing 2 yards.
Ball carrier number 8, Mason McGriskin.
The X-Men, knowing what's coming with McGriskin now, knowing that he's a threat on the ground, and stuffing him here, giving no yards. And now here comes the Gators punt team.
As Guadfell makes his way back out onto the field here for the Gators.
Guadfell has not had the same punts in the second half. Temperature definitely much lower. Muscles are getting tighter, so maybe that's a factor. But so far, we haven't seen those same punts in the second half as we saw in the first.
We're at the 3-minute mark in today's game here on Coulter Field. 25 apiece for both teams. Guadfeld bringing it in. There you go. A big boot there by Yanni Guadfeld.
Lots of room for the returner.
Royer looking to bring him down, can't quite do so, and then finally down at the 35-yard line.
On the punt number one, Yanni Guadfeld. Return number 2, Le 2.
And there's the punt that we usually see from Guadfell.
54 yards on the kick, return of 11.
And good job there on the coverage. Gabawaye not necessarily making the tackle, but getting just enough to slow down the returner. So he stumbles, and then the rest of the team can get him and finish the job. 2:41 left. Fanyan has the ball.
Crowd's trying to get the chant going. Fanyan rolling out to his right, airing it down the field towards Blackwood. No flag down on the play. They like that matchup up against Zachary Foster.
Yeah, they've been targeting Foster all game, but just nothing there. Ball was a bit behind and not the best adjustment by Blackwood there, stopping his feet, just getting tripped up. And it's a second and long here on their own 35.
We'll see what Fanyan can do here. Fanyan, quick pass out to Bussey. Bussey with a lot of room and a lot of speed. Bussey getting wrapped up there by Guedfell. Sneaking in. Doing a backflip to get up there, Yanni Guedfell.
And not enough here for the first down, but I love the call here. Get Bussey some room and force someone to make an open field tackle. We had one guy slow him down and the second one to bring him down, and now we're back with the St. FX punt team. This fourth quarter so far has been a punting game between the two teams. And just remember that number 11 in that purple jersey can make something happen on any single play.
Capriotti out here, 2:19 left in today's game. Capriotti doesn't quite get under that one as Hosang comes away. Hosang to his right, trying to beat a man that beats Blackwood. Hosang still marching forward. Gets up towards the 43-yard line as O'Shea Hosang.
Max Capriotti, the return number 11, Le 11, O'Shea Hosang. Tackle number 15, le numéro 15, sur le plaqué, Joe Hancock. 36 yards on that kick, return of 9. But
not to go back on a previous play, but what was different with Hosang's little celebration there and McGriskin's earlier? I mean, I don't know if it's because he was a quarterback and they expect him to be a little nicer, but I don't know. That's in the past. Control the controllables, like Coach Sheriff would say.
As McGriskin makes his way back out onto the field here for the Gaiters. Successful on his first drive to move the chains. Hasn't quite been after. McGriskin will air it out. Underthrowing Burnett. Looked like it just slipped out of his hands there.
McGriskin loves to attack the seams here against the St. FX defense. Again, always with the fake run. Then attacking the seam here with Burnett. And tight, tight window there. Lucky that didn't go the other way.
As we'll see McGriskin back here in the backfield with Shalu and Burnett, second and 10 on their own 43-yard line. Gaiters wanted to move the chains forward. Hand off to Shalu with absolutely no space.
Ball carry number 27, event set, David Shalu. Tackle by number 21, event.
Nowhere to go there for the running back. Trying to go wide and attack those corners, but Gaiters punt team back on the field.
Coming up with the tackle there was Nathan Kayuet. Selling in front of the crowd after that one. So Guedfell comes back out to punt the ball. It was a 24-second drive there for the Gaiters. As Guedfell gets under this one. A lot of room here for St. FX. A lot of room as the receiver Isaac Umbotimbe comes back to center field.
Great job here by the returner. Let's see here how he's following his blocks. He gets the ball and he starts by going inside, but then he sees the blocks he has on the outside and then just it's open field. Turn on the Jets, able to make another man miss, get another 6 yards. Great job there by the returner. And just like that, we're at center field with St. FX with the ball.
Fanyan, another screen pass out to Ud. Ud now.
Completed pass number
2 yard gain around for Zach Ud.
And here's the screen play. Receivers blocking down the field, very important. Let's see the blocks here. Not much for Ud, getting 2 yards on the play.
1:32 now. X really just needing a first down here. They got Hadley on the sideline.
Never sleep on the kickers, always such an important part of the game. Can make a huge difference here.
Fanyan looking downfield, missed coverage, puts it right out of reach to Blackwood.
And a missed opportunity here by the X-Men, so close. Fanyan again with the extra protection, had all the time he wanted, and just misses a few yards off. Gaiters get lucky there that the ball wasn't in the bucket. And now we have a minute 10 left in this game with the X-Men punt team coming on the field. Now the question is can the Gaiters offense get something going with 1 minute left?
Capriotti coming away here to punt the ball. O'Shea Hosang, the magician here, bobbling that one, reeling it in. Hosang a lot flags down though, as he gets brought down right around the 25-yard line.
Flags on the flag here, I would guess that it is a holding on Bishops. I don't think it was a no yards. Putting the Gaiters in an even tougher field position if that's actually the case.
So we'll see what the call is here. It does look like we will be.
And it's a holding against the X-Men, but an illegal block against the Gaiters, which I believe nets minus five. They're backing up.
Doesn't look like it.
Okay, seems like it's offsetting.
Illegal block on Bishops. Deux infractions, une de chaque côté.
Here's McGriskin trying to lead his team into a last-minute Big Bowl victory.
Just under a minute left, 59.5 to be exact. Mason McGriskin with Marco Briones. Big-time players make big-time plays. Let's see what McGriskin could cook up here. Dropping back, McGriskin gets that batted down, an incomplete pass.
Crowd not happy there with the X-Men doing some little extracurriculars there, and the player seems to be okay after taking a long knee. And the Gaiters in very tough field position here. If they do have to punt, the X-Men won't be that far from a field goal position. It's a very important down here.
Second and long, McGriskin drops back in the backfield. Finds Pierre Mas. Pierre Mas needs to cut upfield, cuts upfield. First down, Gaiters.
That was a huge first down for the Gaiters. Very important because now, if ever they would be punting, at least it's not an automatic field goal for Hadley. Again, I've said it and I've said it again, he is an X factor in this game. His range is so big, and Canadian football, those posts are right on the goal line.
McGriskin and Briones. McGriskin drops back once more. Up in the pocket now is McGriskin. Go Mason, go. Out of play now is McGriskin.
McGriskin here, not seeing anything, and just using his legs here to get a 5 yard gain for his offense, making it a much more manageable second down here on the Gaiters' own 30 yard line.
Second and five now on their 30 yard line. The X-Men have been getting to the backfield. We'll see if they're successful here. Put some pressure on McGriskin. A handoff to Shalou. Shalou trying to jump over a player and brought down there by the X-Men.
Ball carrier number 27, Levitsev, David Shalou. Tackle 72, le 72.
Let's see here, Shalou getting the ball and trying to go up on top, but just being short, and when you're that close to the first down, everybody likes a good hurdle, but when you're that close to the first down, you just want to see your running back put his shoulder down and try to get that first down.
And so we'll have a timeout here for St. FX.
St. FX is going to have 26 seconds on the clock, which is a very long 26 seconds.
And they got themselves a dangerous man returning the ball here. Is Harrington.
Gaiters doing a great job in the first half on coverage here, but 84 has had a lot of nice opportunities here returning the ball in the second half.
Guadfell ready to punt the ball off here. Guadfell getting under that one. Harrington letting it bounce. And a flag will be put down. No yards. So a 5-yard penalty there.
Yeah, that's going to be a no yards on Bishops. Very tough for the Gaiters there when it's a short punt like that.
No yards on Bishops.
And St. FX will get the ball first down on their own 47.
And no better player to have the ball than Silas Fanyan. A playmaker here for St. FX offense. Joined with him is the leading running back in the league, Malcolm Bussey.
And I would keep my eye on number 7, Blackwood. They love that matchup, and there he is.
And they get him. He makes a player miss as he gets brought down closer to the 50-yard line. 9.8 left on the clock now.
Fanyan here loving this matchup once again, going to Blackwood. Blackwood always able to make a first guy miss. And now the X-Men are on the Gaiters' 49-yard line, and they are very close to being in field goal range.
Fanyan bringing the ball down, hand off to Bussey. Bussey gets brought down in the backfield. Or close to, up to the line of the scrimmage. Bussey went 3.8 now as they'll bring.
Correction, 27, back set. Malcolm Bussey. Tackle number 25, the bank.
Looks like they're bringing Hadley out onto the field. This will be a monstrous kick here for Ben Hadley. And Zach, you said it at the start of the game. This is the X factor. We will see if he can ice this game here. 3.8 left on Coulter Field.
I would love to see the record books right now to see if anybody's ever completed a 57-yard field goal. But do not forget, the Gaiters do get a shot here at returning the ball.
As he puts it up.
And it had the distance.
Gervais needs to get out of the end zone. Gervais gets out, and we'll see him slide down. So we are headed on into overtime here in the Big Bowl.
And what a game here between the X-Men and the Gaiters, number 1 and number 2 in the conference, number 6 and number 10 in the country. And this game has not disappointed. It's been Gaiters in the first half, X-Men in the second half, and let's see who takes the extra time.
Format for overtime will be a coin toss. Each team will have possession on their 35-yard line.
They had it.
I dreamt we had cable internet.
Oh, sweetie. We've always had cable internet.
Once you're used to Bell Pure Fiber internet, anything else is terrifying.
And so coming back now into overtime, it looks like the Gaiters will start off on offense here as they head on up in front of the home crowd.
And now to recap the overtime rules, it is a shootout format. So basically both teams will get the ball on the opponent's 35-yard line and they will get a fresh set of downs. If, for example, the Gaiters score a touchdown, I believe they might even have to go for two. And then after that, the X-Men get the ball. And they need to match the points to keep the game alive. Or if they don't, the Gaiters will win. So very interesting here to see how this is going to play out.
McGriskin brings in the ball, dropping back to throw. McGriskin throwing towards the sideline. There he finds Vayette once more as he gets shoved out of bounds.
Great
He's
job.
Having himself a game.
Great job here by Vayette, 89. Good control here again. Nathan McGriskin has the arm to throw that ball fast. A little toe tap here on the sideline by Vayette. Good job.
The Gaiters facing an injury bug. You see Brendan Griffith hasn't been back into the game. Kirion hasn't been back into the game. On defense, Alex McDonald hasn't been back into the game since the second quarter.
I'm just sending positive vibes here to that Gator bench. Hate to see it, but it does seem like Kirion has his throwing arm in a sling, so no official injury report, just what we see here from the booth.
As McGriskin brings it up, a handoff. No, he doesn't. He keeps it himself. Faked me out on that one, and he gets brought down.
And the X-Men have done a great job here preventing McGriskin to getting any yards since that last big run.
As Gervais come out, looking to kick a field goal here.
Now this is important because now we know that if they're starting on the 35-yard line, the X-Men are pretty much already in field goal range for Hadley. They just tried a 57-yard field goal and it had the distance, just not the precision. So this is a big field goal here, 35-yard line. He's done two of these so far.
Xavier Gervais, 35 out.
And that is good.
Field goal is good. That's what you see, number 12, the Dudes, Xavier Gervais.
Great snap, great hold, great kick. Gaiters have 28. The X-Men take over. In this overtime, they're going to take over at the Gator 35. So technically, right now, if they have the ball on the 35 plus 7 yards, quick math, he's a rat at 42. Ben Hadley could definitely make that kick. So all they want is not to fall back. They don't want to lose any yards here. I would expect them to maybe even go conservative here, go for a few runs. If they get a first down, then attack.
Especially with who they have in the backfield here, with Bussey joining Fanyan. Home crowd making some noise. Fanyan dropping back, looking deep. He's got Blackwood. Missed coverage. Blackwood coming down with it.
Incomplete. He didn't hold on to the ball. He's making his case to the ref. You can't expect that to be a catch if you can't hold on to the ball. He gets the ball here. And no, as he falls, he loses possession. Still arguing with the ref. But it'll be an incomplete pass there.
Second down.
But man, did the Gaiters catch a break there. No pun intended.
Second A beautiful throw there by Fanyan. He had his receiver. He was favorite receiver so far this game. Loving the matchup. Just couldn't come down with it as Zachary Foster stripped that one out of his hands. And we'll see what Fanyan does now. Dropping back in the pocket once more. Fanyan under pressure, rolling out. Throwing this one up and towards Ud. Ud doesn't get a foot in bounds, so now we'll have a third and long here.
And here he comes, the X Factor for the X-Men, Ben Hadley. Let's see here if Hadley has ice in his veins, going for 42 yards. He's made a 45-yard kick, missed a 57. Can't be mad after that. But he seems cool as a cucumber right now. Gator crowd being as loud as they can. They know that if Hadley misses this kick, the game is over and the Gators are Big Bowl champions.
We'll see what Hadley has here. Hadley putting it up. And straight through is Ben Hadley.
And once again, Hadley getting the field goal, bringing the Gators offense back out on the field, and the game is not done yet, folks. Like we said, if they're starting at the 35-yard line, all the X-Men have to do is not lose any yards, and they're in field goal range. This is very favorable for the X-Men. And now I believe it's the X-Men's turn to go first on the 35-yard line. So now we've seen the recipe here. They're trying to go deep. They're attacking number 13, Foster, on the Gators defense. They know they have, they seem to know they have a mismatch there with the DB and the receiver. And they're attacking it. And now the Gators are asking their crowd to make some noise.
It will be center flex ball.
Fanyan back out of the huddle here. First and 10, 35-yard line. We'll see if they can move the ball now. They took two shots down deep.
And again, look at number 80 at the top of your screen. I wouldn't be surprised if he adds to the protection, giving more time to Fanyan. And there he is.
Hand off to Bussey. Bussey trying to get towards the outside. Rene Zivat coming away with the tackle.
And here, despite not getting much on the play, great job by Bussey, not losing any yards here and able to stretch out and at least go back to the line of scrimmage. And oh, it does seem like he lost 1 yard.
So we'll see what Fanyan could do now.
Hadley staying warm on the sideline.
Fanyan dropping back under pressure, finds Bussey. Bussey makes a defender miss. Royer coming up with a tackle. Leading the team in tackle, making an important one there is Gab Royer.
And again, this is another big kick. But this doesn't mean if they make this kick, the game's not over. The Gators have a shot here. Even if they make the kick, the Gators could either tie the game and continue the overtime with another field goal, or if they drive down and score a touchdown, the game could be theirs. But let's see here if Hadley has another one in him.
Ben Hadley.
From 39 yards.
An impressive kicker here. Special teams player of the week last week puts it up. And no question about that one. Straight through the uprights.
Hadley is automatic. Automatic.
He is cold.
And here come the Gators now. Starting on their 35. Now if they get a field goal, they stay alive. If they get a touchdown, they win the game. If they don't, they lose.
McGriskin and Briones in the backfield for the Gators. Dropping back is McGriskin. He finds open is Gabin Lur deemed down there at the 30-yard line, so they'll move the ball up 5 yards.
Yeah, if you catch the ball on the knee, you are down, and I believe Gabin Lur here had the knee down. Yep. Second down.
Again, we've seen this play plenty of times. The Gaiters going after those corners, playing deep cover three.
McGriskin drops back. Flutters that one. It looked like it was a miscommunication, missed route there.
Third down.
Yeah, I believe he was going for Pierre Mass, but just miscommunication there because there's no one in the area. Pierre Mass was going for the corner, then cut in on the post. But it seems like McGriskin threw the corner, so not sure if there was a conversion rule there. But it doesn't matter anymore. We have Xavier Gervais now attempting his longest field goal of the day, 37 yards. This is to stay alive in the Big Bowl.
Xavier Gervais trying to match what Ben Hadley just did. Gervais puts it up.
Has the leg, and it's
and
good.
Through. Kickers going back and forth with each other right now. We got a shootout here.
And what did I say at the beginning of the game? Don't count out the kickers. Now we have both of them right now being the X factor for their team. And Xavier Gervais keeps the Gaiters alive. And now it's the Gaiters' turn to start on offense.
So both coaches will actually come out and have discussions with the referee.
And I believe this is different from the CFL where there's no limit. We're going till a team wins. There's no tie games in U Sports. We're going to go until a team wins and another one loses. I mean, of course, we can't give the Big Bowl to two teams at the same time.
As the Gators' offense will stay out on the field. McGriskin and Briones. McGriskin drops back. Under pressure is McGriskin. He jumps up into the play. Mason McGriskin, a flag down on the play.
On the rush number eight, LeRitt, Mason McGriskin. Flag on the play effects.
Let's see, there is a flag on the play. Let's see if we can spot it here on the replay. And I believe it will be a hold. Brutal penalty there again for Bishops. Just once again shooting themselves in the foot. And I believe they will now be at 11 penalties for 87 yards this game. And now we are potentially out of field goal range for Gervais.
First and 20 here on the 45-yard line for McGriskin. Trying to lead the Gaiters downfield. McGriskin finds Briones. Briones met. Trying to fend off a couple tackles. Holding on for dear life there was Josh Connors.
Not much there. McGriskin going to his running back here. Nothing downfield. Trying to give hit the ball to a playmaker there. And this is a very important down because, again, with Hadley as a kicker on the other end, St. FX could practically just do a couple runs, try to make it closer, but we know he's in field goal range right away. So this is a very important second and long here.
Second and long as McGriskin will look downfield over towards Lur. Gets the team back up towards the 35, it looks like.
Great job here again. Going after the sidelines here with Gabin Lur. Great catch, and now the Gaiters are going to be on their 34. And let's see how long this kick will be for Gervais. Does he have another one in him? It'll be 42 yards for number 12.
Gervais putting it up. Does it have enough? It doesn't have enough. Returning the ball here is Zach Ood. As he'll just bring it down, it looked like he had a lot of room.
Yeah, especially a speedster like Ood. I'm surprised he just didn't try to end the game and go back all the way. I mean, we're not even talking about field position, so I don't know why he would slide down like that. Maybe just being extra safe here, knowing his kicker has the leg, so not trying to risk a fumble or something, but could have went for the score. Now, big priority here for the X-Men is not lose any yards. And even if they did lose a few, they're still in field goal range. So they just got to be smart here, protect the ball, and give their kicker a shot to ice out the game.
Fanyan with Bussy. We'll see what the X-Men do here. 31 apiece in the overtime period. Bussy gaining possession here, making a couple defenders miss. Grudfeld looking for the ball. Bussy's got a death grip on it.
Gators doing everything they can to tear the ball out of Bussy's hands. Bussy able to make a guy miss. You see everybody there going after the ball.
8 yard game.
So second and two now for the X-Men. Fanyan with Bussy once more.
Again, Hadley has the leg, but the X-Men won't mind a first down here, making it even an easier chip.
Bussy gains possession, and he'll get brought down right at the first down marker. They'll move the chains forward here, St. FX.
Good smart run here by Bussy.
Tackle number 35, Latonsky.
Not doing anything fancy, just getting the yards. Now the X-Men approaching you here.
So we'll see what Fanyan has here. First and 10 on the 25-yard line. Fanyan hand off to Bussy. Bussy bouncing through the middle. Gets wrapped up by there by Rene Zivet.
And again, I wouldn't expect anything else but runs here. There's no point in risking it with a pass, even if Fanyan has been playing a great game throwing the ball. You're in field goal range, play it safe, and you know what they might do here? They might even just think about which side does Hadley prefer. Does he prefer being on the right hash, the left hash, the middle? That might be what determines this next run here.
Bussy bouncing towards the outside once more.
Good job here by the Gators, but here comes Ben Hadley, number one in points in the conference.
51.
Was 12 for 14 before this game. I don't believe he's missed a single one so far. He has a long of 45 yards. And this will be on the 31, well within his range for number 23, Ben Hadley.
Ben Hadley looking to ice the game.
And the Gators trying to make a play.
As Hadley puts this one up and straight through, icing the game. Ben Hadley got ice seeping through that right leg of his right there.
And just like that, St. FX win the Big Bowl once again and stay undefeated within the conference since 2019. Gators knew that they had this game, but weren't able to do anything in the second half offensively. But one thing's for sure is that these teams will meet again, and it'll be in the playoffs. So this is a tough loss for the men in purple, but there will be a rematch in October.
And so tonight's players of the game are presented by FG and Associates, securing financial success for Bishop's alumni coast to coast and proud partners of Gators Athletics. For the Bishop's Gaiters, none other than number 5, Gabriel Royer. And for the St. FX X-Men, the man, the myth, the legend, the guy who's got ice seeping through his leg, number 23, Ben Hadley, who iced the game here for the Big Bowl on Coulter Field as both teams shake hands at center field. What an amazing game to have been able to broadcast, to have been able to witness, if you're even just sitting in the stands or viewing online, one of the games of the years between the two top teams in the AUS. And we will see them, hopefully, both teams make their ways back and meet up in the playoffs once more. It'll be a very exciting game. And so on that note, we will send it on over to the introduction of the trophy, and we'll say our goodbyes here. Hope you guys enjoyed and look forward to seeing you guys next. October 27th is the next home game.
We welcome Bishop's University Director of Athletics and Recreation, Matt McBride, and St. FX Director of Athletics and Recreation, Leo McPherson. They are joined by Brian McAnulty and Mary Adams. The Big Bowl Trophy was donated in 2002 by the family of Reverend H.R. Cannon Big and has been awarded after competition between the St. FX X-Men and Bishop's Gaiters and USports football. A beautifully crafted Big Bowl trophy came from England and was generously donated by St. FX alumnus Brian McAnulty and his wife Mary Adams in honor of McAnulty's grandfather, Reverend H.R. Cannon Big, a rector in Sherbrooke, Quebec from 1915 to 1940 and a multi-sport athlete. We ask the captains to please come forward for St. FX. Champions of the 2023 Big Bowl. Bishop's University Athletics thanks you for attending tonight's game. It was presented to you by Bell. Get on Canada's best 5G network today. Visit bell.ca/5G. The Gaiters are next at home on Friday, October 27th, when the Mount Allison Mounties are in town. Kickoff is set for 6 p.m. Don't forget to head over to the gate for today's post-game reception. For updates on the Gaiters anytime, stay tuned to Gaiters.ca or any of our social media networks using hashtag GatorNation. Thank you for joining us. Please get home safely. Mesdames et messieurs, merci de votre présence ce soir au Coulter Field. Prochain match, vendredi le 27 octobre pour la visite des Mounties de Mount Allison. Le vote d'envoi, 18h. N'oubliez pas la réception d'après-match au gate dans quelques minutes. Et en tout temps, vous allez sur les médias sociaux avec le hashtag Gator Nation. Merci de votre présence. Conduisez prudemment et bon week-end. Salut!